Welcome to Jewellery Maker. It is Monday morning. I'm Carol. Carol Roach, GIA, AJP. Do you know what that stands for? Do you know what AJP stands for? Accredited Jewellery Professional. Apparently. Well, there we go. So yeah, I'm with you for the next 4 hours. We've also got the lovely Irene with us. How are you, Irene?
I'm lovely and I'm happy, and how are you? And thank you very much for having me on the show.
Ah, it's a pleasure. Did you have a nice weekend?
Yeah, I did. It went really quick.
What did you do?
We went to see family, which was nice.
Oh, nice.
You know, the men in the pub and having a few toddies and
oh, really?
The woman driving home. But
No,
I don't mind. It was okay. It
yeah?
was good. Yeah, got to see my sister-in-law and that. Love it. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. So they live close by?
No, close enough for us to love each other. And then when we've had enough of each other, it's like, we'll see you later.
No, I know exactly what you mean. Nice weekend then.
Yeah.
I saw my mum and dad yesterday. That was nice.
Oh, nice.
Yesterday afternoon. It was very nice indeed. There we go. I hope you're good. I hope you've all had good weekends. Matt, have you had a good weekend? Yeah? Anything exciting? Anything life-changing?
I was doing
Christmas. You
were what? Doing sound.
Really? Ooh. He was doing sound for a folk festival. That sounds awesome. Whereabouts was that?
In Evesham.
In Evesham. That sounds brilliant. Mm. Ooh, good fun. We've got Amelia back, everyone. Amelia, can you come and flash us your tan just quickly? Because this is sickening. I mean, I look like an albino next to her, but look.
I am a little bit tanned, aren't I?
Oh, my word. Yes. Look at that tan.
It's not fake, I do promise. Yeah.
Look at that. That is a proper tan.
But you've got a September holiday coming up, so...
I do have a September holiday coming up. We're going to go to Spain, which is going to be lovely. We've got Claire, who's directing. Claire, how are you today, darling? Good weekend? Anything life-changing happening at the weekend? Had a barbecue. Nice.
Ooh,
barbecues can be life-changing. Yeah. Once you go charcoal, you never go back, apparently. But see, we've got a gas barbecue, so it doesn't taste quite the same. But anyway. And Phil, what about you? You right? Good weekend? Anything exciting happen? Another barbecue? Oh, the same barbecue. Okay. Same barbecue. There we go. Awesome. Right, okay, we've got an amazing show for you today. We've got the yo-yos back in stock. We've got brand new strands. We've got a really super special deal for a strand of Saphire and Emerald coming up on today's show, and Ruby. I have been a little bit naughty with this, and I have been bullying our management team upstairs. This is coming up on today's show. It is absolutely astonishing. If you're lucky enough to be watching over the weekend, maybe you saw strands similar to this, maybe you didn't. I've got a strand today which I have really been very cheeky with. But anyway, it's coming up a bit later on in the show. We've also got, it's coming up about midday, we've also got beautiful natural fluorite coming up, which is just gorgeous. I love the banding on this. It's simply amazing. So beautiful, beautiful, beautiful fluorite coming your way. We've also got a little half-hour section coming up at about 11 a.m. Where we're going to be giving you loads and loads of pre-birthday treats at about 11 o'clock. About half an hour of just brand new strands. I'll give you a very quick look. Very quick look. Very quick. There we go. Very quick, very quick, very quick, very quick, very quick. Okay, there we go. Don't be getting too excited this early in the morning. Text in if you have any questions for Irene. Any questions for Irene? Oh, what's up? Gemstone what? Gemstone film names. Oh, dear me. Phil, as you know, producer Phil, loves a pun. He absolutely loves a pun. We've got some ridiculous bundle names today. You know, cringeworthy. And he wants you to text in your favourite gemstone film names. So, Phil, can you give us two examples of gemstone film names, please? Findings Nemo. Okay. Saving Pyrite Ryan. Very good. Pirates of the Caribbean. Yeah, that's a good one. Who? Pre-Night at the Museum. Very good. Yeah. Sorry, Streetcar Nelian Name Desire. Things like that. So if you feel like texting in any gemstone film names, then please do. Our text number is 60777. Start your text with the word JM Studio. Standard NY charges apply. Sorry, I can't stop playing with my belly button. Over the last 48 hours, it's literally just popped out. You know, like when you put those things in a Christmas turkey and it pops out when it's done? Like the boop button thing. Feels ever so weird. Right, okay, early bird special. Right. We've got Pebble Jasper. This is, oh, there he is. Beautiful early bird. I haven't seen the robin for the last few days because I haven't had any bird seed out. I need to replenish the bird feeder, then he'll come back. He's gorgeous, isn't he? Beautiful little robin. Right, okay, so what have we got? Pebble Jasper Cabochons. Now, these are totally and utterly natural. I just love the natural qualities running across this gemstone quality. Look at this. You're guaranteed 250 carats of this incredible gemstone. Guaranteed. Okay. You could be getting three cabochons like you are in this pack here. Beautiful quality. You could be getting four cabochons. You could be getting two. You could be getting five. It all depends on the size of the cabochons. You are guaranteed 250 carats of this incredible genuine gemstone. Whether you're going to be getting square or kind of rectangular with truncated coordinates or fancy shaped or pear shaped, really is the luck of the draw. I don't know exactly what pack you're going to be getting, but you are guaranteed 250 carats of this incredible gemstone. It is entirely natural. Beautiful quality, gorgeous markings. I love these kind of pinky colours you're going to be getting across here. And this one here is much more stony in colour. Really, really beautiful quality. All really, really highly polished. Now, with the collections of cabochons we've had over the last few weeks on Jewellery Maker, we've been able to bring you fantastic carat weights, fantastic deals. We've been able to bring you on average kind of, I don't know, between 500 and 700 carats of a particular gemstone. And we've been able to give you a fantastic price point like $21.95 or $24.95. This collection of Jasper is for anyone who has seen those collections and thought, you know what, if only if it was a little bit more conservatively, well, a little bit more conservatively priced. Today, you are going to be getting 250 carats of your Pebble Jasper, and this is your price point today. It's £8.95. Absolutely wonderful. So really, when you look at this and you think, do you know what, I really do want the opportunity to set a cabochon. I want to be able to use a cabochon, but I don't necessarily, but my budget doesn't necessarily stretch far to paying £21.95 or £24.95. £8.95, go for it. Either give us a call on our free phone number, which is 0800 644 655, or get involved on our website, which is www.jewelrymaker.com. it's simple, it's easy to get involved. Now, we've given the great thing about cabochons is we've given these cabochons over the last few months to so many of our guest designers, whether they specialise in wire work or soutache or macrame or kumihimo. There are dozens of different ways in which you can set cabochon gemstones. You don't have to set them into wire. You can do something as simple as gluing them onto a foundation fabric, or gluing them onto a finding, and there you have it. You know, you've got a ready-made piece of jewellery. £8.90. You what? You're going to do what price? Oh my word, we're going even lower. I don't know if I've ever seen cabochons go this low. Seriously, £6.95? I don't think I've ever seen a set of cabochons go to such a low price point before. That's amazing! Oh my word! Phil, that's incredible! Irene, we're going to be seeing a demo from you a little bit later on in the show where you're going to be setting, effectively, a cabochon into your jewellery. What I love so much about the cabochons you get from Jewellery Maker is there are so many ways in which you can set them into your jewellery. You're not limited to just setting them with wire work. You can set them in dozens and dozens of different ways. I mean, we're going to be seeing a demo with you later on where you've set it with lace, aren't
we? Yeah. I mean, the thing is, sometimes people are a little bit scared of them because of the size. But yeah. I think once you start playing around with them, all the shapes that we bring, there is no way that you can't find some sort of medium that will complement it, because just set on its own like that, sitting there in your hand, is absolutely stunning.
Yeah.
But we're gonna encase it in a little bit of lace.
Uh-huh.
So it sort of pops the colour out.
Yeah, gorgeous.
So, yeah.
Yeah, there are so many ways in which you can set these. Mm. You can set these, as Irene says, with lace, with foundation fabric, with findings, with soutache, with wire work, of course. There are just dozens and dozens and dozens of different ways in which you can do this. Lots of people coming through to get this. Lots and lots of people coming through on the web and the phone lines there. Do make sure you check your baskets out as quickly as you can. Well done. £6.95. Now, moving on from one amazing deal to another amazing deal. I can't believe We're able to do this for a clearance price, by the way. This is a clearance deal for... Hang on, I've just got to itch my back. Itch my back. Itchy back. No, that's not going to work. That's a bendy ruler. So, I've got a clearance deal for Prey Night. Now, just ignore the details for a second. Oh, that's better. Okay. Ignore those details for a second, just there. And just have a look at this. Bicolour Prey Night. Top drilled, hand faceted, hand drilled, Prey Night, faceted pear drops. Great, aren't they? Gorgeous. Totally natural. No heat treatment, no dyeing process. You're approximately going to be getting 8 gemstones on this strand. Okay. All entirely natural. Now, we very rarely see Prey Night in this kind of size and shape. We normally see them rounds or maybe nuggets. Very, very seldom do we see these in elongated faceted drops, but you've got a strand of it here. Now, the greatest thing about the deal we're going to be bringing you today with this strand of Prey Night is you're not just going to be getting one. Do you know what? I've got two. That's great, isn't it? Two strands of Prey Night elongated faceted pairs. That looks great, doesn't it? It is going to be a clearance price. I've already got people confirming on the web and the phone lines for this, which is no surprise at all. Because you know what? You're not actually going to be getting two strands. You're actually getting three. Now, honestly, three strands of bicolour Prey Night in elongated, hand-faceted, hand-drilled drops. So you're approximately going to be getting 8 gemstones on each strand. So that's 27 gemstones approximately across the three strands. Your deal for this bundle today is mesmerising. £29.85 should be your price point. And you know, we've got loads of people confirming at £29.85. That works out to what, £9 a strand. Today though, you're not paying anywhere near that. Today for all three, and I know this sounds like it's not a real deal, but honestly, it is $9.95 for the three strands. Oh my word. $9.95 for the three strands. Oh my word. The amount of people adding this into their baskets has just gone bananas. You have got to check your baskets out because I haven't got an unlimited quantity of this. It's amazing, isn't it? Well done. $9.95 for all three strands. I've got loads and loads of people coming through to get this. Well done. It's a true triple trouble deal here, where it's $9.95 for three strands of Prey Night. $9.95 for that on its own. It's pretty amazing, yeah? Today, $9.95 for all three. All three strands. Incredible. You are just going absolutely nuts for this. I'm so pleased for you. Well done. Lots and lots of webinars coming through for this. I've got people multi-buying coming through to get threes of these. Well done. I've got telephone bidders as well. Absolutely amazing. Well done. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Well done. I've got people texting in gemstone film names. This one's going to be interesting. This is from Leanne, who says, romancing the gemstone. I like that. Nice. Do you remember that? Romancing the stone. With Kathleen Turner. Is it Kathleen Turner? Yeah. No. Yeah. No? Yeah. It is Kathleen Turner. No, it's not. No, it's not Kathleen Turner. Kathleen Turner was the one in Crocodile Dundee, wasn't she? It was Michael Douglas, wasn't it? And Danny DeVito. It is Kathleen Turner. I'm sure it's Kathleen Turner. Who's the woman who was in Romancing the Stone? It is Kathleen Turner. Brilliant. Okay, awesome. Diamonds are forever. Not quite a pun, but that's okay, Georgina. We'll take that.
Oh, that's a song.
What did you say, Irene?
Well, that's a group.
What take is? That. We'll take that. You're yeah. in the swing
yeah,
of all
we'll
this
take
now.
That. Yeah,
we'll
yeah, yeah.
That. Especially if it's a diamond ring that they nice.
Bev says, hi, Carol. Could you please... Oh, sorry. Can I please say sorry? Yesterday, you read my Wall of Fame out, but I didn't... But I did it in capitals. Won't do it again. Bev, bring on the deals. I know. Bev sent her Wall of Fame entry in capitals, so I shouted the whole thing. I shouted the whole thing. Yeah, if you can do it in italics next time, I'll change. Well, I have to kind of emphasise every word then, won't I? If you're doing it in italics. Don't do it in windings, though, because I won't be able to read that. right, okay. Now, coming up, we're going to be seeing a demo with Irene, where you're going to be using some glue, aren't you, for your first demo? Was that for your third kit, second kit.
To be fair, we can use glue, but we didn't have to use glue.
We didn't have to.
But I wanted to have a little play with the glue because I haven't used that one yet.
Have you not?
No.
Oh.
I've used the other one, but I haven't used that one. I quite like the look of it. And
I've read
the instructions.
Me and Irene both love
glue. All the things that glue can do in that tiny little tube.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yep. Absolutely.
It really is amazing, isn't it?
Mm.
Let's have a quick look at this. Made in the USA, I didn't know that. Oh, wow.
Oh. I think it's a variety of materials. Is it on the front, Carol?
Was it on the front?
Yeah, on the top bit.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Fabric, textiles, beading, bridal and floral, arts and crafts, costuming applications. Costuming. I was thinking, what does costume? What are these words? What is this word? Costuming applications. So sorry about that.
Oh, bless.
Definitely not consummated. home decor and decorative embellishments, wood, paper and photos, acid-free and lignin-free.
Yeah, basically your acid-free is good because, you know, if you're doing your resins and your polymer clays and you're putting them into a bezel,
yeah,
and you want to, say, put a photograph in,
yeah,
the acid-free means that it's a really good glue to use, so it doesn't age and tarnish and turn your photographs a yellowy colour. So it's
you really do know your glue, don't you, Irene?
I've seemed to be getting this reputation.
She does. She's the glue lady. We love her. Right. Okay. So I've got loads of people coming through for this. You've got your precision applicator here for your fine detail work, your cement glue. Plus, you've also got two A4 bead mats. If somebody please could stitch loads of these together and make me a duvet out of this, I would be eternally grateful. Oh, here's your price. Oh, it's just so lovely. It's just so.
That's good.
I could actually fall asleep there. That's like £6.95. Well done, everyone.
You'd pay that for the glue on its own.
That's a really good point, actually.
You know what I mean? You would, wouldn't you?
Absolutely, yeah.
And I like my glue.
And these kind of glues are going to last for ages and ages and ages, aren't they?
Yeah, the good thing about that glue, because obviously it's got its sister glue, is that it's got a very fine nip on it.
Yeah.
So I always tend to get the tip of that and just rest it on my index finger, wipe the top, and then I always balance it to put the actual rod back into the glue.
Yeah,
that's what's really good about it. But just use some sort of, a varnish, like a Vaseline, a cream to put on there so it doesn't stick. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
clean
yeah,
it with that or a
yeah.
wet wipe and then just clean it with that. Put the end cap back on and it lasts forever.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah.
You'll find you will hardly use any of this, which is absolutely brilliant. So it will last for a long, long, long time. Your bead mat, fantastic for putting your gemstones on, for laying them out, and also when you do cut strands, you'll find that the gemstones won't roll off these. They will stay nice and central on your bead mats. You've got two of them as well, which is absolutely brilliant. So if you're going to be working on different projects, or if you're going to be working with a particular strand that's really precious, maybe this gorgeous strand that we've got coming up later on with the ruby and the emeralds and the sapphires on, you know, and you want to kind of lay it out, or you want to kind of give it a bit of a roll, which kind of takes a lot of the fingerprints off, then absolutely fantastic. These bead mats are so, so, so useful. Also, if you're into hammering, if you do lots of hammering work, you might want to put your metal block on top of one of these mats as well, because it does deaden the noise a little bit. And also, I mean, I tend to have a bead mat here just to rest my wrists on when I'm showing you strands and things like that, just because otherwise it just gets a bit sore on the underside of my wrist. So I tend to put a mat there so I can rest my wrists on it. So if you find that you've got slight arthritis or kind of joint issues in your wrists or in your hands, it's quite nice to put your wrists on those to work on. You're going to be getting two of your A4 bead mats plus your glue as well. And the great thing about having this little precision nib on the end is, of course, you can get right into those tiny little nooks and crannies, those little corners of your jewellery work. So you can glue the smallest of spaces. Plus, they can clean your glasses as well, which is really good. Okay, right. Teresa in Bridgend says, hi all. Been ill following impromptu stay in hospital. Oh no. Found Jewellery Maker on TV, macrame, kumahimo, jewellery making, etc. Don't have time to go back to work. Well, there you go. Just don't go back. Yeah. Stay at home. Yeah. Watching Jewellery Maker, making jewellery. I hope you're feeling better soon, Teresa. You know, a lot of people do find us when they're off work poorly or they've got a few weeks holiday or whatever. You know, that's how a lot of people do find us, which is quite amazing. And it's a kind of a common thing which a lot of people do share, which is great. People sometimes find us sometimes once they've retired and they've got a little bit more time on their hands. It's a really, really wonderful kind of community feel here. That's why I love working on this channel anyway, because everybody here, whether you're a tech op, whether you're a floor manager, whether you're a producer or a director or a guest designer or a presenter, everybody really, really cares about the channel. We all really care about the quality that we bring you and the kind of shows that we bring you and, of course, the deals that we bring you as well. $6.95, fantastic. Well done, everyone. Awesome. Okay. Now, coming up now, rose quartz, peach shell pearl. Oh, yeah. Lovely. Oh, wow. Ah, this is nice. We've got a new budding beader. This has been made by Anne. Do we not have Sue JG anymore then? Oh, so we do have Sue JG still. We've got other budding beaders who we give bundles like this to, and they are given loads and loads of findings to work with, and they get to make whatever they like out of the bundles that we give them. Oh, my word. That is gorgeous. Beautiful 10mm rose quartz coins, which you can see Anne has used in these pieces here. And 6mm shell pearl rounds. So that's your rose quartz there. There's your shell pearl. I'll show you the two strands together, actually. Shell pearls look... Oh, they're so perfect. It's a lovely, lovely size. Just the right size for a necklace or a bracelet. And the kind of necklace you could wear every single day. Sometimes shell pearls are extremely large, and it might not be the kind of size that you want to wear every day. But with these... Absolutely 100%, you could wear them every single day, couldn't you? And they've got that perfect pearl quality, but without that kind of price tag which you'd expect to get with genuine freshwater culture pearls, which are perfect rounds. Here are your 10mm rose quartz coins as well. Absolutely beautiful. Gorgeous, gorgeous colour on these. Anne has set these with silver, which I think looks great. You could also set these with yellow gold. I think with rose gold they would look absolutely beautiful as well, or copper, or even some of our antique bronze. And I'll tell you what else they'd look great with. These cabochons that we've had today for the early bird special. They look great with these cabochons. Beautiful, aren't they? Absolutely gorgeous. They're really, really bright. They'll go superbly with our first kit today, which has got rose quartz and shell in it and some lace. It's going to be a fantastic price point for these today. You've got your rose quartz and your gorgeous shell pearl 6mm rounds. Here's your deal today. Give us a call. Absolutely gorgeous quality. £6.95 for the two strands. Absolutely gorgeous. And these are two really versatile strands, aren't they, Irene?
Really lovely. I mean, even if you're just going to make a pair of earrings, if you count how many hearts you've got on that strand, are they the heart ones?
They're the coin ones.
Oh, yes. So those ones, if you put a round, small, probably 4mm bead at the bottom and then the top,
that's
and then
nice
just
idea.
Make a lovely pair of delicate earrings,
yeah.
And you were doing your shows, you imagine how many of those you could sell?
I see a lot of people wearing rose quartz as well. It's popular gemstone, isn't it?
It's a very loving stone, and especially good for the youngsters, you know. Sort of, my daughter's 26, and all her friends love that pastel pink colour.
Yeah.
It's a warm colour. It's
a really unusual gemstone, because a lot of people love this gemstone because of its myth and legend, because of its links with romance and partnership and unionship and friendship. Mm. But also that colour, it's unlike any other gemstone, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Yeah. I've, I've, and with the clear colour of that, it bounces off all the colours that you're wearing.
Yeah, gorgeous,
you know,
yeah.
You, like the blue that you're wearing, it'll look beautiful with that. You know, if you're wearing deep colours.
Yeah.
It just, and I think, I've always said it, I think pink goes beautiful with greys, you know, a nice grey pearl.
Oh, it does, yeah, beautiful. Really, really does. Mm, yeah, whether you're really going to be wearing nice neutrals and your kind of camel colours and your kind of smoky tones, or whether you're going to be, as Irene says, wearing your bright, vivid colours, it's really going to go with it beautifully. $6.95, well done for your two strands there. Gorgeous, gorgeous quality. Awesome. Right. Now, Phil, we've got kits coming up. We've got at 11 a.m. we've got about a half hour section of brand new strands. Sorry, say again. Yeah, can do, yeah. We've got a little section coming up at about 11 a.m. this morning of brand new strands that you've never seen before. All of them are going to go down to birthday, pre-birthday treat prices. Not long to the birthday, under 2 weeks. I'm so excited about it. We've got moonstone, we've got coral, we've got this. Have a look at this. Ah! Woo! Brand new, never been seen. I cannot wait to bring you this. Absolutely astonishing. It's a brand new strand of banded agate. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 brand new strands coming up at about 11 a.m. They're all going to go down to pre-birthday treat prices. A lot of them are going under £10. You're going to absolutely love it. It's going to be the most amazing section. And like I said, the reason why we're bringing this to you is because we need to really, 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 really promote the birthday celebrations this year, because it's normally over one day. Today, because this year, because it's our fifth birthday, we're doing it over 5 days. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It's going to be amazing! Right. yes. You've been involved with the birthday DVD, haven't you, Irene?
Yeah.
What did you make?
Hessian necklace.
Oh, gorgeous.
Nice.
Can't wait for the release of that DVD.
Yeah, I know. And I'm away as well, so
I
have to catch up.
Where are you?
I'm taking my husband on holiday for his birthday.
Where are you going?
I can tell you now, he's going to the Dominican Republic.
No.
Yeah, and on his birthday, he's going to be swimming with sharks. And I've got to do it as well. Yeah, so if we don't make it back after the 5th, you know that the sharks were hungry.
Oh, don't say that, Irene. Right.
Should be fun.
Wow, is it a big birthday?
Yeah, because I've just had my birthday.
Because you just had yours. You went to America. You went to Las Vegas and New York, didn't you?
Yeah.
It's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
John, but, my husband, if you're listening... Yeah. All right. Okay, here we go. Now, I've got a great deal here for you. Phil, use your head pin. Head and shoulders above the rest. I like thinking up new and exciting names for hairdressers. Hairdressers always have the really amazing names like Curl Up and Dye and things like that, and Main Attraction and things like that. And, you know, I love A Cut Above and things like that. Sandwich shops always have good ones as well, like the Upper Crust. And, I don't know. Yeah, anyway. Right, okay, here we go. So, use your head pin. You are going to be getting a total of 300 head pins here. If you're sitting home saying, I don't know what a head pin is. What does a head pin do? Free with your first order, you get a free tutorial DVD and a free tutorial booklet. Inside the booklet, there is a section on findings, and I shall read you what it says about head pins. Head pins. A head pin is a thin piece of wire with a small ball or flat area at one end and is available in different lengths. Head pins are used lots in jewellery, but are most commonly used to attach drilled gemstones to jewellery. The round or flat ball on the head pin holds the gemstone in place. The wire passes through the gemstone, then is normally made into a simple loop or a wrap loop. Simple, yeah? We all know what a head pin is now, yeah? Brilliant. 100 of these head pins with a gorgeous kind of bead cap quality on the end. Absolutely love these. These are all silver plated copper. 100 of those, 100 of these head pins with a gorgeous heart shape on them. See that little heart shape? Super cute, isn't it? And 100 head pins that are like... Oh, this one, find a star one, became heart ones. Like this one, with a star on top. Absolutely gorgeous. I haven't come across anywhere else that brings you so much variety with its head pins, with the decorative quality. They really, really are so, so, so decorative. And because, of course, you've got, you're going to maybe have a gemstone sitting right up against there, and you're going to make a loop, this really is the only part of the head pin you're actually going to see. So it's lovely that it's really beautiful and decorative, isn't it? It's just gorgeous. So 300 in total, 100 of your hearts, 100 of your stars, and 100 of your bead cap ends as well. Silver plated copper bead, head pins here. All yours today, 300 in total, £9.95. Brilliant, absolutely fantastic. £9.95 for all 300. Now, you may have heard some of our guest designers talk about bubble bracelets and bubble necklaces and bubble rings, which is basically where you get loads and loads of gemstones, put them onto head pins, make little wrap loops on top, and then feed it onto either a piece of elastic or onto a piece of chain, and you have a beautiful bracelet that makes loads of noise. It makes a kind of like a jingly jangly noise, and it kind of feels beautiful. It looks absolutely gorgeous, and it's one of the simplest designs you can possibly make, but it's so unbelievably effective. If you've got 300 head pins like you've got as part of this deal here, you could do that kind of design. The head pins are such useful findings, aren't they, Irene? You can never have too many of them, I don't think.
Oh no, and you've just said what I was thinking that I would do because of the quantity we've got there.
Yeah.
But you've got to remember as well, Carol, is that we've got fine and thicker head pins in there. So if you've got really, if you've got really dainty stones.
Like the Gems of Distinction ones, yeah.
Yeah, they're great for that.
Perfect.
Really nice for that.
Perfect. I'm also thinking, if you're making lots of charm bracelets, just little stretchy bracelets with little charms on, you could use these as your little head pins to put your gemstones on to feed onto just stretchy bracelets. It doesn't need to be complicated, does it?
And the other thing, is what I have done sometimes when I'm working with the kits, if I haven't got a jump ring to hand, the quality of our head pins, I do make a jump ring out of those.
Ah, good
call. Because sometimes if I'm a bit stuck for a wire that's matching, because sometimes you do get certain gauge wires that are not got the same colour tone. So the quality of those are nice and strong, and they're good enough to make a jump ring out of.
And to be fair, Irene, they're really long as well, so you could actually get away with making a jump ring or another eye pin, maybe out of half the head pin, and then using the head pin for its purpose. You know, you can actually cut these into half if you're going to be using smaller gemstones with these. You really can, can't you?
And a stem to put one of the kits that's coming up a bit later.
Yeah.
I use two gold head pins, and I put them opposite each other and wire wrap around them, made it into a triangle, and then I used it as a base, as a structure, to make that pendant.
Yeah, so you can absolutely use, you can use these as frames, I guess, as it were.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Yeah, to weave onto. Because they do have that beautiful strength. They are precious metal plated copper, so they're going to have that lovely, lovely strength through them. £9.95 for 300 head pins there. Well done, everyone. Lots of people coming through for these this morning. Wowza. Brilliant, well done. Okay, sorry, say that again. Which one then? Oh, Phil. Okay, this is one of his, this is one of Phil's favourite bundles today. He mentioned to me last week how much he was looking forward to playing this bundle because of its name. This bundle is called I'm Sorry, This Is Low Stock. Don't encourage him. Irene, please.
Sorry,
don't.
I got the giggles today.
I'm sorry, this is low stock. Okay. You're going to be getting dark grey and navy blue sari yarn. And you're also going to be getting orange coloured sari silk as well. Now, so many of our guest designers love using this incredible product. The yarn itself looks a bit like rustic wool, I guess. It's not kind of like a fine wool that's going to give you a very, very kind of fine knit. It's really, really chunky. It's very, very fibrous, as you can see there. Absolutely gorgeous. You're going to be getting 95 grams in navy blue and exactly the same in this gorgeous kind of dark grey colour. It's absolutely gorgeous stuff. And you can do this, you can use this with knitting, you can do macrame with this, there's so much you can do with this. Guest designers who absolutely love this include guest designers like Gemma Crow, who absolutely loves this yarn and silk. It is gorgeous stuff and it gives you the most wonderful texture. The silk, this is beautiful stuff. This is proper, you know, this is moving into kind of using fabrics as part of your jewellery. And it's all been twisted together. The actual yarn, the actual silk itself is probably just over an inch in width. There's so much, again, that you can do with this. And hopefully, over the next few months, we're going to be running some sari silk and yarn workshops here at Jewellery Maker as well. This is gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. Each one is going to be unique. Each one's got different colours going through. It's beautiful, isn't it? Now, this is really, really, really low stock, this bundle. Your original price is £17.85. We're going to be taking it low because it is very, very, very low in stock. As the name would suggest, I'm sorry, this is low stock. Dear me. And here's your deal. £7.95. That's a full... Well, that's pretty much a £10 saving you're making there on this deal today. I must just say as well, if you are, or when you are, adding these to your order today... Please remember, you're only paying £2.95 per order. These are going to take up a little bit of room in your parcel, aren't they? I mean, they're not going to take up a huge amount of weight, but they're going to take up a little bit of room. You're not going to be paying any more in P&P. It's just £2.95 per order, okay? Regardless of how much you add to your order, whether it's everything on today's show and the designer inspiration show and the late show, it's just £2.95 per order. So you can have that confidence knowing you can add whatever you want to your order and you're not paying any more in P&P, even though this is going to take up quite a bit of room. This is really, really, really low in stock. It should have been £17.85 today, £7.95. Absolutely awesome, awesome quality there. Well done. Now, moving on now to Irene's Cha-Cha Challenge. Where is Irene's challenge? Yes, I've got it here. Yeah. Here we go. I've got it. Okay, shall I sing the challenge song? Difficult song. Don't expect you to get involved because it is quite a difficult song. Challenge! Challenge, Irene. Your name is just the right amount of syllables and letters and, you know, Irene, you can definitely come on the show again.
Oh, thanks.
We had Fleur yesterday. It was a total disaster, the challenge song. I had to say challenge, Fleur, and give her another syllable, because it just didn't work. Jan is even worse. challenge Jan. She's just, on that basis, I don't think Jan should be allowed back on the show, to be fair.
Oh, she's nice.
You'd have to work with her. Tell you what.
She's
terrible,
nice.
Terrible.
No, they're all nice, actually.
They are, aren't they?
Yeah.
We are lucky, aren't we? Everyone's lovely.
I say that every day.
They are, though, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely.
Normally, in a place of work, there's kind of one person that you're like, meh. But, you know, everyone's lovely, aren't they?
You walk in, it's quite outside, you walk in, and everybody's going, morning, hi, hello, and I don't see negativity around at all. It's really nice. It's nice.
It's lovely. The only negativity you get is with Phil's puns. That's the only negativity I get. I feel negative about his puns. Ivory and fuchsia. Well, no, there's no pun there, so that's good. This is... Oh, you didn't make this bundle. Okay, fair enough. This is your comfort zone, isn't it, Irene?
Yeah, I seem to be told that I'm the ribbon lady.
You are! The ribbon and the glue lady.
Yeah, you keep calling me the glue lady. I'm going to have to get out of that title in case I get stopped.
This is gorgeous stuff, isn't it? It really, really is. I think the reason why you as a guest designer is seen as somebody who works a lot with kind of fabrics and ribbons is because you seem to be able to look at something like this and think outside the box.
Mm.
This is really, really beautiful Hessian ribbon that we've given to Irene today. You can see, when it's on the reel, it's got this lovely kind of tight weave to it, but as soon as you start to take it off and do this with it, kind of pull it apart, it just really comes to life. It's just beautiful. Mm. There's so much you can do with this, feeding wire through it so you get something really beautiful and structural, using in fascinators, making bows out of it, doing so much with this. I've seen Irene use this in a couple of different designs and it really has looked really, really effective. You're going to be getting in total 10 metres of your fuchsia Hessian cord. You're also going to be getting 10 metres of your natural Hessian cord as well, again with this beautiful weave going through it. Now, what will allow you to kind of add other things to this as well, Irene, but what kind of ideas do you have, design ideas do you have with this so far?
Well, I've weaved it, I've coiled it, I've plaited it, and I think I'm going to loop it today. And
ooh,
I
nice.
Might, yeah, a really quick, easy technique, because I've done it in one of the other kits that we're showing today.
Yeah.
But just to show you how, how the two different types of cords and ribbons can look totally different, but has the same technique. And it's a really quick, easy one to learn.
Is this the one you've done with the pendant cord? Which is absolutely gorgeous, I have to say. It's a really, really effective, effective design.
Yeah. Really lovely quality product that is as well. Beautiful.
So 20 metres of your Hessian cord here. Your price point today, absolutely amazing. And you will be seeing some absolutely gorgeous designs coming from Irene today, because she is going to be replicating a design that she's done in one of her kits today, which is gorgeous. £6.95. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. What I love so much about this material as well, Irene, is that it does cross over into different crafts. So you can use it in scrapbooking, you can use it in flower arranging, you can use it in, oh goodness me,
you can make furniture trimming out of
it. Oh yeah, lovely.
You know, use it as a piping. You can, like you say, use it for your fascinators.
Oh, definitely.
I've seen so many people now having the little girls are having these beautiful big flamboyant bows on headbands.
Yeah, beautiful.
They look dainty in the summer. That's a great product. But just remembering, because of the word Hessian, we sometimes think it's a bit uncomfortable, but it's really smooth.
Yeah, it's really, really lovely. Mm-hmm. It is fibrous, but it's not. But it's not what I would call scratchy, kind of like a sacking material. It's a really, really smooth quality. Mm-hmm. It's unbelievable. You've got to get hold of this. And we do invest a lot of time and energy making sure that all of these materials are going to be really, really nice against the skin. And this really, really is beautiful against the skin. So gorgeous quality there. Well done, everyone. Lots of people coming through to get that. And as we go throughout the show and catch up with Irene and see some of her designs, more and more and more of these will go. So just be aware of that. So do check your baskets out. Alison in Hampshire has been buying three of these. Well done. If you do want to multi-buy these, please just go for it. Speak to the call centre. Oh, no, she's got four. Speak to the call centre and say, hi, can I add four of these to my order? And they'll say, yeah, no problem. If the quantity's there, you can do that. Or if you want to alter the quantity that goes into your basket on our website, just literally do that on our website, and you can add as many of these to order as you want within the realms of quantity. Gorgeous, well done. Right, so Irene's got that kit, first kit. Right, this is such a beautiful one. You're going to be getting fabric in this kit, two sets of lace. We've become really famous for our lace here on Jewellery Maker. It's something that we do very, very, very well indeed. I'm very proud of it. The feedback I've had from our guest designers and from you about our lace has been absolutely amazing. There are so many different ways in which you can use this. There are so many different designs you can get from these beautiful pieces of lace. You can stiffen this lace, you can cut this lace up, and it's not all going to unravel. It's a very, very high quality, quite a heavy lace. Let me show you some of these qualities. So you've got a beautiful floral piece here. Look at the different stitches going through there. Isn't that gorgeous? You can sew this onto a top, you can sew it onto a pair of shoes, glue it onto a handbag, make it into a beautiful glove. You know, absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous quality. Next piece. You're going to be getting 10 pieces of lace in total, by the way. Here's your next piece. Beautiful quality. That one there. The great thing about this is you can cut all of these edging flowers off, as Sheila did actually in one of her designs, and made them into a pair of earrings. And she just stiffened it with a PVA and water mixture. And you can stiffen the pieces of lace. And this piece of lace here remains intact. It's not going to unravel or anything. Gorgeous. The quality is amazing. The kind of price points we do for our lace as well are just astonishing. You can make beautiful masks out of this piece of lace, which looks amazing. Look at that beautiful butterfly piece. Isn't that gorgeous? It's a lovely cherub one there as well. Detailing is just beautiful. There's even more lace. I've got 10 pieces of lace in total. 10 pieces. This is nice. This is a really, really beautiful piece, this one here. It's like a kind of a V design. It's a little bit crimpled, but there we go. Isn't that beautiful? You could even sew that onto a V-neck top if you wanted to. If you're not, you know, to kind of sew onto a V-neck of a top, onto the back of a cardigan as well. In fact, I've got a top, a maternity top, striped maternity top, and on the shoulders of it, it's got two pieces of lace just sewn on there. And you know, I mean, you can do that with any kind of T-shirt that you've got. Any kind of cheapy cheapy T-shirt that you've got, or V-neck, you know, just sew bits of lace onto the shoulders. In fact, Charlotte, one of our guest designers, did exactly that, and it looks great. You know, hers look great with beads on and everything. Beautiful quality here, lovely, lovely quality of lace. And if you go to any kind of big haberdashery, my word, to find pieces of lace like this for the kind of price points that we do for our lace is just amazing. So, 10 pieces of lace. Okay, you're also going to be getting genuine gemstones. Let's have a look at them. Two strands of faceted shell pearl in brilliant white and baby pink. Absolutely gorgeous. So they're both 8 millimeters in diameter. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. How about rainbow coated rose quartz 6 millimeter plain rounds? I don't remember the last time I saw mystic rose quartz. I absolutely love it. It is a really delicate coating that we put on the rose quartz to give you this beautiful mystic quality. So you get this gorgeous, can you see the beautiful pinks and purples and blues and yellows and golds coming off there? It's wonderful, isn't it? Excuse me. Beautiful, beautiful rose quartz there with your coated mystic quality there. Really, really delicate coating. You've got rose quartz hearts as well. Beautiful puffy hearts. Look at these. 10 millimetres in size. Oh, they're just gorgeous. And you're also going to be getting shell. Now, these are top drilled shell beads. Irene's actually used one of these as a cabochon, which I absolutely love, because you can get away with doing that with this strand, and you'll see why in a second. These are just gorgeous. Rose, they're described as rose shell. You're going to be, they are 35 by 25 millimeters in diameter. Just look at that quality. Oh my word. I was actually only saying yesterday, in the summer and in the spring, you see so many people wearing jewellery that features shell. You're going to be getting a drill hole right at the top of the gemstone, so if you do want to use it as a cabochon, please just go for it. You've got that lovely kind of dish concave quality on each one of these, and then as you go over the top, that wonderful convex quality with that smoothness. On this strand, approximately, you're going to be getting 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 of these in total. They are just, they are ethereal. You can wire wrap them. They make a great pendant, earrings. You can even make a really funky ring out of these as well if you wanted to. I mean, they're just absolutely beautiful. I love, 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 love them. You're also going to be getting two lots of cord. Pink waxed cord, 10 metres, and navy blue waxed cord as well. So this kit is really, really, really diverse. It's extremely large. You're going to be getting 10 pieces of lace, 20 metres of waxed cord, and you're also going to be getting 5 strands of genuine gemstones. Now, you should be paying £48.85. If you just look at the lace, there are 10 pieces of lace here. Just for the lace on its own, that price point there is, what, under £5 per piece of lace. In a haberdashery, I'd expect to pay more than £5 for that piece of lace, wouldn't you? Would you? I certainly would. In fact, Gemma Crowes, one of our guest designers, gave a load of this lace to a friend of hers who's a milliner, just to see what her professional opinion was of our lace. She couldn't get over the quality of the lace, the fact that you could cut it up and it wouldn't all unravel. That's a testament to the quality of the lace. The heavy stitching quality, the detailed quality, the amount of different stitches and designs available in the lace, and also the price point she couldn't get over as well. Now, if you just look at this price point, £48.55, just for the lace on its own, that's less than £5 per piece of lace, and everything else is free. Today, we're not saying £48.55. This is your deal for the entire kit. You're going to love this. It's going to sell out in seconds. £27.95! And do you know what? At £48.55, I had loads of people confirming. At £27.95, oh my word, even more people are coming to the web now. Oh my word, loads and loads and loads of you. That is just incredible. £27.95. just incredible. Lots and lots and lots of people checking their baskets out now. Do it quickly before this kit sells out, because we do have limited quantity of this kit. Less than 70 chances available. It is going to go on today's show. That is amazing. Right, I'm going to bring a yo-yo over for Irene to show us. Irene, I'm just going to blow my nose. What are your thoughts on this kit when you first opened this kit?
Oh, absolutely love it. I think this is one of the comfortable, softest colours that I've ever worked with. I fell in love with the pearls. Those lovely, that every time you look at them, they're just shining. The clarity, the warmth, I just picture myself being on a beach with them. I absolutely love them. I think these are probably the nicest pearls I've ever seen, honestly. I know that a lot of people like the plain ones, but you put this up against your neck and every time you move, it just brings a massive, like a crystal shine to them. They're gorgeous.
With shell pearl, we have the luxury of being able to facet these, which we don't have with genuine freshwater culture pearls. And you do get this sparkle and this luminescence which comes from these shell pearls. I mean, look at it in this design here, next to the shell, next to these beautiful shell top drilled shapes. Oh my word. Not only have you got this gorgeous pearlescence from the shell top drilled drops, but look at the sparkle. And it is almost a sparkle that you get from the shell pearl, because it's been faceted. You get this amazing inner sparkle, and it isn't a sparkle because you know these gemstones are opaque, but it looks like they're coated in something almost. It's beautiful.
Purity of them, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, you wouldn't believe it's a shell, because it's so clean and pure and shiny and smooth.
I tell you what,
gorgeous.
Irene, I love what you've done with this mystic coated rose quartz here.
I like that one.
It's just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful little mystic coated bracelet. It's just so sweet.
Be lovely for bridals or little, you know,
definitely.
Bridesmaids.
Flower girls. Mm. Oh yeah, just gorgeous. Mm. Love what you've done here with the lace as well. You've layered on top of the lace. You've put some beautiful fabrics on top of the lace, which looks absolutely gorgeous. Look at that, isn't that beautiful?
Mm. And the large shell that we've got there, what I've noticed, because they are natural, sometimes you get that sort of air that makes a little hole in them.
Oh,
so
yeah, okay.
I use that to the advantage.
Yeah,
and there
beautiful.
Was a little air hole at the front, so I put a head pin in there. Mm-hmm. Going back about all these lovely head pins we've got, I use a nice head pin with a pearl and put that in the front, so I used it as a feature, which
beautiful.
Was quite nice.
Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Now, this piece on the end here, you've encased one of the shell pear drops with lace,
yeah,
which I absolutely love. I just think it's such a lovely, lovely thing to do. It allows the kind of pearlescence of the shell to come through, and it's a lovely background for this lace, don't you think?
Yeah,
you've got
like a matted tone coming out with the shell that makes it pop, like you say.
Show us how you did it, Irene.
Yeah, okay. Well, what we're going to do then is, obviously, you find one of the lace strands out of the kit that we get, which is brilliant, okay? And what I found in there was one of the flowers. So I thought, well, as we all do as guest designers, we think, well, how can we make this sort of work with what we're doing? So I just snipped this section out. And because these are such beautiful shells, I thought what we could do, instead of actually encasing from the outside, what would happen if we encased on the centrepiece? And because the lace is so beautiful, I thought, well, how about if we sit them together? And then I found that it looked quite nice over there.
Yeah, it really does.
And literally what I did then was I turned it round and I got some beading cord, or you could use a double-sided cotton of a choice that you want. This tail here is actually longer than the other one, so I use that as the top one.
Okay. Yeah.
And all I did then was, I didn't go right to the end, I just came slightly, a little stitch about a couple of millimeters in, okay, where you get the wider section, because I want that to overlap, because it is slightly bigger than the shell that I've got there. And then I've just connected my cotton.
Okay.
Pull that one over, and then what I do then is I just literally go up and down through my cotton,
yeah,
and the tail of the actual lace, bring that one over, and then I'm going to catch it onto the adjacent one. Bring
lovely
that one down.
This piece of lace really is almost made for this design, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Don't worry about that popping out just yet. I've got that where I need it. I just thought it went really well, and I thought, oh, I do like that. And funny enough, you know, when you have visitors in the house, you're putting your samples sitting there, and they're going, oh, I like that, I like that. And then don't forget, don't stop here. What you can do then is you can add, you know, head pins with smaller pearls. We've got those beautiful
rounds. Yes, you can add on to this design, can't it? Which is
and
really
use
great.
It as a base, definitely. And I'll just follow that round, you know, anti-clockwise for me.
Uh-huh.
And then up and down, like I say, encase it. And as you can see, it's looking quite tidy. It's not messy either.
No, it's not.
But I think I'm quite a quick crafter. I'm not somebody that takes hours and hours over something to, you know.
That's good.
And I don't mean that disrespectfully, because I would have had the time, but sometimes when I see something so beautiful, I'm a little bit impatient. I like it to...
you
want to
do it there and then, don't you?
Yeah. And I want it to be able to wear, and things like this, you know, if you're going out the weekend and you find that you've just bought a beautiful, say, cream lace top, you imagine making something like this to go with it for the... You know, for that evening, it'd be
fabulous.
Yeah,
that's just going to look great, isn't it?
Yeah. So that's
beautiful.
All we've done there. Okay. And then what I've done is, you're going to keep doing that until you feel it's secure. And then once you do, all you need to do, good old scissors, snip it off, and off we go. Okay. Sorry, I was a bit far out there.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
So that's how easy it is there. And if you want to make the actual connection piece to hold it onto the chain, so we're going to have that piece there. Make it whatever way you want to make it, really. You can have it, you know, a piece here. And, you know, so it's just, once again, using our, you know, the stash of our head pins. I snipped one end off here.
Yeah.
And then I made an eye pin loop on this side to match, and I would make two alike there. Okay, but just to connect this, it was as easy as this, because these shells actually have got the drill hole coming through.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah. So what I did then, I thought, well, how can I do that? And I thought, I don't want the cotton to be my base, because that doesn't look right.
Right.
So what I decided to do then was, hopefully it's worked, because I've never done it before. But there's always the first time.
Okay.
Okay, so what I did then was, I've done it in a darker thread so you can see. So I got the chain and I used one of the loops. It doesn't really matter what chain you're using. It can be any of our stash that we've got. And then I went
through the drill hole.
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah. And then what I did then was that connected here for me.
Oh, fab.
Yeah. And then I made that to the length I wanted it to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that looks great.
Right. It will look better in a minute. And then what I did then was I snipped it to the length I wanted. You see, roughly about there.
Yeah.
Let's have a look. There, like so. Then I caught it on the other end, and then I went back through.
Ah, that's awesome. So you don't even see the beading thread, do you? You don't even see the cotton thread that you've used there.
No, once you've done it, you know, a bit tidy.
Oh, that's so cool. I love it.
Yeah. And then obviously here, what you'll do then is just put a little bit of a jump ring there and start adding it onto the necklace how you want it to wear, like
gorgeous.
The image that we've got.
That's awesome. This kit, $27.95. I've got almost 20 of you with this kit in baskets. Please check your baskets out. Well over half the quantity of this kit has now been allocated, so do add this onto your order. Now, just something I wanted to show to you very quickly, and Irene's also going to show us how to use this, is in this particular necklace here, you've used our amazing yo-yo maker.
Yeah.
And I think it will be really, really beneficial for us today to see how you actually make the fabric yo-yos out of this. Mm. I remember the first time we ever played the yo-yo, and we had so many people with texting in questions, queries about this incredible tool. So if you do have any questions with regards to the yo-yo maker, please do send us your text, because Irene is the lady in the know. So do send us your text. We'd love to hear from you. We've got the first one coming up now. I've got three on today's show. I've got a heart shaped one, and I've got this round one. I think I've got another round one as well that's slightly larger one. Price point wise, they're all going to be exactly the same. This is such a lovely addition, I think, to this to this necklace, and it's such a lovely addition, I think, to any piece of jewellery that you make, because they really do make wonderful little kind of rosette style pieces, don't they?
Yeah, and they are really, really easy to use, and they come in full instructions, which are great because you've got lots of colour instructions because I'm more a visual learner. And then it is so simple to do. And as long as you can get the material to go inside and let it little pop, as we call it, so it just connects. That's really all you need to do for what type of materials you use. So with the ones that we've got that I've done in our kits, I use a little bit of stretchy material to see if that worked well.
Lovely.
And I reversed the one that you're looking at now. I actually reversed it so it wasn't the smooth side. Instead of tucking the tail in,
side.
Yeah, I used the opposite side because I like the texture of the material.
Yeah, it's almost feathery, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Yeah, and then on one of our other kits that I did, I used the lace that we've got in one of the kits, so I can show you that a bit later. And I also used a bit of felt. So really, a lightweight material. I don't think the denim would go in unless it was a thin denim.
A thin denim, yeah.
So just think about that. But as long as you can get the material to pop inside, that's
so it. You've got your material inside the yo-yo maker now.
Yep.
And then what do you do? You stitch around it, don't you?
Yeah, literally all the way around. And what we'll do is, once it goes in, it will clip, okay? So what you'll see is it'll clip in, and at the back, you're going to see, I'll show you on here, this is the same technique, just a different shape.
Yeah, we'll bring you the heart-shaped one a bit later on in the show.
Yeah, okay, and what you do is you've got a scallop on the opposite side, and what you need to do, and you see the teeth on this side.
Yeah.
Okay, these teeth have to, when in between the material, will need to clip in so that you see the gap in here.
Yep.
If you don't see that, then your needle will struggle from going up and down.
Because that's basically what the holes are for. It's to show you where to stitch.
Yeah, yeah. And you'll have a starting point and you'll have a finishing point, okay? So I've used one of our Hessian bags because, to be fair, these will look quite nice. And I'm going to use this towards my challenge.
Yeah, they do look gorgeous to look, Anza.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah. And then what you're going to do is you literally will go in and out of the Hessian bag. I've got to make sure I put mine on right, actually. Let me see. Let's do it again so I can show you. Okay. And there is a little notch that it tells you to guide by, but I've got to be honest.
It's a line, isn't it?
I don't think I've really seen it. did you hear it click?
Yeah, you can hear it click. Okay. Brilliant.
The best way I do that is I look where the actual wide part is, and I can see the gaps in between. The best way to do this is you can cut first if you want to. Sorry about the bag. I feel a bit disrespectful.
Right, don't worry.
We're recycling, aren't we?
We are.
Yeah. Okay, so what we do is down, and let's just hold that with the thumb. This is the easiest way. And literally, now I've gone down anywhere. If you are right-handed, come down so you've got the scallop on the side here. Because my scallop's this side, if I go across there, I've connected it towards the plastic. I can't do that. It will not come out.
Yeah, okay.
I have to cut it. What I need to do now is I'm going to go, and I'm going to come back this way.
Yeah.
Okay, because I need to go in and out my work. So that's in. So it's just a simple down and up.
Yeah, perfect.
Okay. Now, if you're going to use the beading cord, you only need one strand. If you're going to use a cotton, you may want to use two strands.
Yeah.
Just for the strength, okay? But, and the other thing I was thinking about, Carol, is if you want structure in this, you know, you could cut a piece of card in the centre, couldn't you?
You did say that earlier on. I think that's a lovely idea.
Yeah. Alright.
There we go.
Yeah. Black on black's not always the best.
That's alright, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
I've got lots of people coming through for this, lots of people adding this to their order. I think these are all kind of first time buyers for the yo-yo.
Okay.
It is absolutely awesome, and it's the lowest price point we've actually done for the yo-yo as well, which is just incredible. Absolutely wonderful. So as you can see, what Irene's doing is stitching all the way around the circle. You'll have a very definite starting and ending point, which will meet each other, and then we'll see what happens when she's finished stitching there. But you can do it with pretty much any fabric. It's got to be a lightweight fabric, as Irene says. If you do it too heavily, i.e. with a denim or with a really thick kind of calico or something like that, then it's not going to work properly, and you'll see why in a moment, why it works so good with a lighter weight fabric. But I like your idea, Irene, of putting a piece of card in the centre of it, just to stiffen it a little bit, give it a little bit more structure.
Well, and the reason why I thought that as well, Carol, was because what you could do then is, you know, these lovely little beads that we're getting, our sea beads.
Oh, yeah,
we're bringing
on the show today, yeah.
Yeah, over stitch all the way around, and that gives it a fantastic effect. Yeah, with
nice
adding
idea.
Those.
Lovely
okay, so
idea.
we've got all the way around, so you can see that's quite quick, really.
Yeah, lovely.
Okay, now all we need to do is, you've got the ridge here, and you do need to cut quite close, so don't worry about that, because those are going to be tucked in.
Oh, perfect, okay.
Yeah, if we leave too much of a gap here, what happens is that has to go inside the pom-pom as such.
Yeah, yeah.
And then it will make it bulky.
So you use it as a guide, I guess,
yeah.
Then, the ridge.
Yeah, unless you want it to be bulky, and you could add a little bit of probably cotton wool in there.
Oh,
you can
yeah.
make it like a pom-pom-ish.
Nice.
You? Yeah,
okay.
So there's a lot you can do with it.
Okay, right. So you're cutting around.
Yeah, and I'm just cutting it, and try not to get your cotton, because I've done that a few times.
And you do this with, you do exactly the same technique on whatever size or whatever shape yo-yo that you've got. Mm. It's a very, very simple tool to use. It's been designed to be very, very simple.
It's a lovely tool. I really like it.
Okay.
I love gadgets and
great,
things that make things different and make it easier to work.
Yeah.
And this definitely does that for you. So this is the nice part, okay? So we've got this here. Okay. And then all we need to do is the really hard thing, and that is put your finger there and pop it out.
Oh, that's really difficult.
Isn't it? Now, here's your teeth. Now, as you can see, if I sewn them wrong, I wouldn't be able to take the two parts apart.
Yeah.
But I've done very well, so all I need to do now is just take that off there.
Yes.
Yeah, and this is where the fun bit is.
I know, this is really fun. This is where you see it kind of transform. It looks amazing. Mm-hmm.
Do you know, I was thinking with the bigger one, I've just had a thought, because you know
yeah,
what I'm like. You could make it like a little sweetie bag.
Oh,
as a gesture,
you could.
Bag,
that's a nice
you?
Idea.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Oh, yeah, one. That's a lovely idea.
Obviously, the bigger one, the better one, because we were given sweeties today, by the
we
way.
We were. Get more sweets in there.
You could fit a little sweetie in there. Look,
you could. A little
yeah.
bonbon.
So all we need to do now is I take my two ends, and I literally will take them, and I will just tie it together.
That's great. Oh, I
yeah,
love this.
And that's, see how that forms a basket? That would be really
oh,
nice.
Beautiful, yeah.
Bag. And then you can do it a little bit tighter if you want to, but you only need to get your knot. And once you're happy with your knot, just snip off your ends, like so. And then you can take like a little pokey tool or anything, and you literally just put your tail ends in, like so. And then you can start adding embellishments. So you can use the front or the back. It's
and what,
really
you've,
totally
and what you've done in the centre of these is lovely. You've added like a little shell pearl in there to kind of hide your workings, as it were.
Definitely.
Yeah.
You see? So that's your smaller one. And it's really pretty. So that's quite a neat one. I'm going to use that, I think, on my challenge.
Because it's so good.
Yeah.
If it looked a bit rubbish, you wouldn't have used it.
Oh, dear. Yeah.
Gorgeous, and that's the size that they end up on. So it's exactly the same technique, whichever yo-yo you use. We're going to be bringing you a larger round one and a heart-shaped one a bit later on the show, but lots of people still coming through for that. Well done, everyone. What a gorgeous little tool. Really great little gadget. And as Irene says, you know, it's going to give you just a different look to your jewellery. Fantastic. Let's go see some of your pieces on today's Wall of Fame. Here we go. I've got number 21 here, which has been sent in by Christine from Ipswich. Hi, everyone at Joymaker. Here's my entry for this week's Wall of Fame. My first attempt at knotting a pearl necklace. Oh, gorgeous. Mm. All pearls and silver findings are from Joymaker. It takes a bit of practice, but it's worth it. Wasn't quite sure how to attach a silk to lobster claw clasps and closed jump rings, but muddled through. Regards, Christine. Christine, you will notice such a huge difference when you do knot your pearl pieces. The fluidity. They're like liquid, the pearls, when they fall in your hand, rather than using beading thread, which is a little bit more rigid. It's a very, very liquid-like piece that you make. And, oh, my word, you can really tell you've knotted that, because it looks great. And that knotting is so regular and uniform.
Very classy, isn't it?
You've done a really good job there, Christine. That's awesome. Well done.
Very nice. I've got number 22. Hi, all at JM. Here is my necklace and my first attempt at pearl knotting with gorgeous silver and champagne pearls. Your lovely little gold plait spacer with a lovely little gold plait spacer. The only thing not from JM is the clasp. I think I've made it difficult for myself, the way I've made it, but I got there in the end. I could really do with a win, as I would love to try again with silver findings. Then hopefully hand it down to my daughter.
Oh, that's nice.
That'd be nice. So I will keep my fingers crossed and wish everyone a good day. Loving the show, and we'll miss Carol and Vicky when on maternity.
Oh, lovely. Oh,
but wish them all the best with their new arrivals. Love, Chris.
Thanks, Chris. Awesome. Beautiful piece there. Well done. Thank you very much as well. Number 23, this is gorgeous labradorite from Eileen in Cheshire. Hello, you lovely people at Jewellery Maker. Attached is my Wall of Fame entry for this week, a simple weave labradorite necklace on silver plaited chain. The photo doesn't do the labradorite justice. It really does look fantastic in the amount of shiller, which is amazing, which is why I've kept the design simple. Good. Nowhere else has labradorite of such consistently great quality, and certainly not at Jewellery Maker prices. Good luck to everyone in Wednesday's draw, and that's Eileen. Thanks a lot for that, Eileen. Oh, brilliant.
I like the idea of them all being together, because it gives a real strong impact. I've got number 24.
Wow, someone's been busy.
Yeah.
Goodness me.
Yeah, very nice. Okay then, it's from Kay. Hi everybody at JM, hope you are all well and dandy. Dandy. Here is my entry for the Wall of Fame for this week. A set of necklace, earrings, bracelets and rings, all components from JM, silver plated chain and smoky quartz nuggets. Do hope they are good enough. I'm sure they are, and we think they are. And I like everyone else, I'm hoping to win. Good luck to all and waffly me. good luck to Carol and Vicky on the birth of their baby soon.
Thank you.
Oh, bless.
Oh, I love
See,
all
we
this
all
love
you, don't we?
That's nice, isn't it? This is gorgeous. Number 25, some beautiful chainmail.
I like that.
From Barbara Duffin in Bournemouth. Brilliant. Good morning to all at Jewellery Maker. Hope you're all well and enjoying this lovely weather. I thoroughly enjoyed Fleur's last DI, and as you can see from this week's entry, it's from the Clock Strike Midnight Kit with the watch parts. Brilliant. They make lovely and different charms, and there are lots left. Looking forward to Sunday's show with more chainmail from Flay. It was a great show yesterday. It was so much fun. I won the Wall of Fame 3 weeks ago and spent it all on jump rings and kits. Good for you. Here's hoping for another win, but good luck to all. That's Barbara. Awesome, Barbara. Well done. And best of luck, darling. Money well spent there. Awesome. Right, okay. We've got coming up seed beads coming up after the break. And citrine coming up later on in the show as well, which is absolutely gorgeous. This is amazing quality citrine. Don't go anywhere. Seed beads coming up in just a few seconds.
Awesome. The fastest way to shop with Jewellery Maker is by going to our website. Just click on the sign up button. Once you've filled in the required details, you can start shopping. You can watch the show by clicking the Watch Live button on the front page. You can also use our refine tool and narrow down your search. Once you've found an item that you like, just simply click on the Buy Now button and the item will be added to your basket. Don't forget you can add as many items to your basket per day and still only pay 1p&p. Enjoy shopping with Jewellery Maker. If for any reason you're not satisfied with your purchase, you have the benefit of our no quibble 30-day money-back guarantee. Just complete the returns form enclosed with your goods and send them back for a full refund.
We all know having the right tools for the job is important, so we here at Jewellery Maker have designed a toolkit which includes all your essential pliers for jewellery making, including round nose and flat nose pliers, wire cutters, as well as a bead reamer, snips and tweezers. You've got everything you need for just £9.95. We provide the tools, you provide the skills. Get creative with Jewellery Maker.
If you're new to Jewellery Maker, simply contact our call centre and we'll send you a tutorial DVD and Get Started booklet, all free of charge.
If you have a question or query for Jewellery Maker, then you can contact our call centre on 0800 644 655 and press option 2. Or alternatively, you can email help@jewellerymaker.com.
Did you know that the Jewellery Maker phone number is free from a UK landline? Now you can spend those extra pennies on more shopping.
Get involved with Jewellery Maker by sending the studio a message during our live hours. You can send a text to 60777 and start your message with JM Studio, or alternatively, go to our website and click on Watch the Live Show, simply type your message into the box and press send. Make sure you stay tuned in case your message is read out. Get interactive with Jewellery Maker.
Chocolate, gorgeous. I'm so excited about this next bundle. Where is it? Oh, there it is, right. Goodness me. This is absolutely extraordinary. It really, really is. Who was I talking to the other day about seed beads? It wasn't on the show, it was after the show, before the show. It was Prue. It was Prue. I was talking to her about seed beads. We were talking about glass seed beads versus gemstone seed beads. There are surprisingly few places actually that can offer you gemstone seed beads. Really, seed beads and kind of seed beading and embroidering with and sewing with seed beads, which have to be gemstones really, which are under kind of 4 mil, 2, 3, 4 mil rounds in size. They have to be that kind of size. Anything larger really isn't a seed bead, so it's kind of 2, 3, 4 millimeters in size. Anything where you're going to be sewing with a gemstone bead or embroidering with a gemstone bead really it's going to be classed as a seed bead. The amount of places that can offer you gemstone seed beads are really few and far between, really. I'm not going to lie to you, it took us years to get these in stock. The reason for it is we were faced with seed beads. We wanted to buy them because of you, because the amount of people saying, please, can you start stocking seed beads? Please, 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 can you start to bring us these incredible beads? We are not going to start to buy glass and plastic and things like that here at Jewellery Maker, because we are part of the genuine gemstone company, and that is what makes us really different. The reason why we don't bring you rhinestones and things like that is because they're synthetics. We only stock genuine gemstone qualities. So, yes, we wanted to be able to bring you seed beads, but they had to be gemstone quality. And that's something which a lot of manufacturers found a little bit difficult to deal with and a little bit difficult to source. The amount of preparation it took us to be able to... the amount of preparation it took us to have to organise and orchestrate for us to bring you gemstone seed beads was on a military scale, really. We had to go to our manufacturers and we had to say, look, we want to do seed beads. They've got to be of a certain price. We want to keep the price nice and low, but we want them to be genuine gemstones. When we first got seed beads in stock that were kind of 2, 3, 4 millimeters in size, they tended to be round about £6 to £9 a strand, there or thereabouts. That was kind of the accepted price point. And really, for gemstone seed beads, that really is superb. The specific tools, the specific drills, the specific skill set, and the specific lapidary skill set needed to facet and to drill seed beads is mind-boggling. Mind-boggling. If you've ever seen anybody who makes or paints little tiny, tiny, tiny models, and I do mean kind of the little, little tiny ones. I know Alison, as well, I guess, as mine as her, her husband, John, makes beautiful little models, and they're gorgeous. And he's got paintbrushes where he's got one hair on the paintbrush and paints their eyes and their mouths, and they're all different. If you can imagine the skill set and the concentration to do something like that, and then you translate it into kind of faceting gemstones and drilling gemstones, it's on that kind of level. Now, what I've got here, and I've already got loads of people coming through for this, by the way, which is hardly surprising. I've got a pack here of 10 strands of seed beads. I have got natural sodalite, natural green adventurine. I've then got red tiger's eye seed beads. Wow! I've also got, what's this one here? Yes, black obsidian. Oh, wow, that's natural volcanic glass, by the way. How amazing is that? Labradorite seed beads. Wow! I don't think... When was the last time we did labradorite seed beads? I don't know if we've actually done labradorite seed beads before. And you've got labradorescence on them as well. Have we ever done labradorite seed beads? I don't think we have we? 2 mils. Maybe 4 mils. Not 2 mils, though. Oh, my word. That's amazing. Snowflake obsidian. Natural. Rose quartz. Natural. Red jasper. Look at the colour on that. Oh, it's gorgeous. Serpentine. Natural. And white magnesite. Natural. 10 strands of seed beads. Now, Irene, you were talking about seed beads a little bit earlier on. Do you have much experience with them? Have you used them before? Do you stitch with them? Because you do lots of... Your kind of jewellery making does cross over into kind of textiles a little bit. What's your knowledge of seed beads? How have you used them?
I love seed beads because I like doing a right angle weave, which is It's basically where you're making a base, so it would be like a brick work, really, and they give structure to. So if you've made a square, for instance, out of beautiful, I mean, this is a crafter's beader's will to get that strand that you've got there.
I know.
I mean, it's fantastic. They're great for filling. They're great for using as a small dainty base. I love making rings out of them. They're great for when you're using your memory wire rings. They look really smart and just, you know, and these are great if you want to just finish off, say, the back of a necklace on a chain and it's got the drop and you just want to put one more of that stone. It just ups the quality of your necklace.
So little final flourishes. I get your thinking, actually, of using this almost as a bezel around a larger gemstone, like a cabochon, using it with the gorgeous shell that Irene had in the last kit. I can imagine these being used as like a little bezel to go around, a bit like putting a beautiful photograph in a frame. I've got my mum gave me a photo yesterday of Hattie and her cousin, my nephew Rufus, in the bath together, taken when they were just a few months old. That is such a beautiful photo, and at the minute I've got it stuck on my fridge. Last night I had it stuck on my fridge, and I thought, you know, that's not staying on my fridge. I'm going to put it in a frame, and I've got a frame upstairs in our loft, which I'm going to put it in that frame, because it's going to make the photo look so much better, and it's going to give it the kind of platform it deserves. This is the kind of feeling that you should get with seed beads. They give other gemstones a platform. They also can create huge amounts of impact on their own. 10 strands of seed beads. £7 to £9 a strand? No. How about £2.50 a strand? £2.50 per strand. Now, you've got a bundle here with 10 strands of genuine gemstones in, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those 10 strands are natural. That's amazing. Is that right, Phil? I think that's right. So the tiger's eye, the jasper, and the magnesite are going to be dyed. So that's 7 out of the 10 strands. That's amazing.
That's a fantastic kit.
I think that's incredible. And you've got really unusual gemstones here that you wouldn't normally see in seed beads, like labradorite and tiger's eye. You wouldn't normally see tiger's eye seed beads. You definitely wouldn't. I don't think I've ever seen labradorite seed beads. And these are proper seed beads. They're 2 millimetres in size. This is a true seed bead, isn't it, Irene?
Oh, they're beautiful. And like you said, the work that must have gone into bring that kit together for somebody.
I know.
That is a beader's
dream.
Oh, yeah. I'm thinking it's absolutely... I love it. Because I was just also thinking you could put them in between, making tiny little fairies at Christmas. You imagine how many they're, a nice big Labradorite as the main focus one.
Yes.
Then put a tiny one of those top to bottom on that.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah.
What a beautiful kit.
Oh, definitely. Absolutely gorgeous. £24.95. I've got loads of people who've come through to get that. Please check your baskets out because we don't have, as I'm sure you can imagine. And I tell you what Gemma Crow's sister does. She just makes loads of stretchy bracelets out of these and just wears them like that.
Mm.
Love it.
Beautiful.
You'd sell hundreds of those, wouldn't you?
Oh, wow, yeah.
Hundreds of those.
Yeah.
Doesn't have to be complicated. Just make stretchy bracelets and wear them like that. I think they look great. Great for festivals. Awesome.
Yeah.
Right, okay. Now, I've got a bundle here, which is probably one of the most useful bundles you will ever get on Jewellery Maker. You ask any jewellery maker out there whether they've been making jewellery for 15 years or 15 days. It is so important that you have a stash of genuine gemstones. You have to have a stash. Your stash normally includes colours and qualities like black and white and neutrals. You'll have some clear gemstones in there probably. You might have some shell pearl in there or some genuine fresh water culture pearls, but it's so important to have a stash. What is a stash? What purpose does it serve? Well, with black gemstones, with things like black agate and black onyx, trying to make decadent evening time jewellery and sophisticated jewellery, not using black gemstones is a bit like trying to make a sandwich without the bread. You know, it's just not going to work. It's essentially a salad. You know, it's not going to be a sandwich, is it? Making daytime or bridal or anything which you want to be light and airy in your jewellery designs without white gemstones is exactly the same. It's almost impossible to do. Now, in this bundle here, you will find colourless quartzite qualities, which are absolutely beautiful, and they will go with everything. And I'll prove it to you, they will go with everything on my desk. Absolutely everything. So what have we got? White quartzite faceted rounds. The great thing about quartzite is you get a consistency with quartzite. Not the kind of thing which you can say about a lot of other organic gemstones. You know, this is going to give you a consistent colour, a consistent texture. So, white quartzite faceted 6mm rounds and 8mm rounds, 10mm rounds, and then unfaceted, highly polished 12mm rounds. Let's have a look at it with the seed beads that we've just done. Does it go with those? Absolutely. Will it go with the strand of ruby, emerald and sapphire I've got coming up later on? Ho, ho, ho! Yes. Will it go with the fluorite that we've got coming up later on? Definitely. There is nothing that this won't go with. This will go with absolutely everything. Absolutely everything. Will it go with silver? Yeah. Gold? Yeah. Rose gold? Yeah. It is like looking at a blank canvas, and it's up to you, whatever colours, whatever qualities you want to add to it, you can do that. It really, really, you are not limited at all with a bundle like this. You can use it all in one go, you can split it up, you can save it for a rainy day, you can have it in your stash and just knowing that you've got it in your stash is absolutely the most important thing, because it helps you rest easy and it helps you make jewelry in a much, much, much more consistent way. Now, £18.80. Looks good, doesn't it? We're going lower. Yeah. We're going lower. We're going under £15 today. £12.95 for your four strands of white quartzite. This is an absolute essential. I mean, this is something you've just got to get, isn't it, Irene?
It's like having the black dress in the wardrobe and the white dress in the wardrobe. You've got to have the white beads because they will balance and complement any other crystal, which is what you're just saying. And wearing them on their own, and this time of year, that's a perfect strand,
isn't it,
strands
just
to buy.
And what I love about this is the fact that it's not like a solid white, like a like a piece of A4 paper.
Mm.
That's a solid, 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 brilliant white. This is more of a translucent white, so it's going to allow a bit of the skin tone to come through, a bit of light to come through. So if you're not somebody who wears a lot of white, I don't tend to wear a huge amount of white. We've got white trousers on today, but I don't tend to wear lots of white against my face. just purely because I find sometimes it washes me out a little bit. This is a much, much, much better way of wearing white because, of course, you've got that translucent quality, so it's not like a bright, stark, brilliant white. It's a much more natural, textural white. Absolutely gorgeous. You could do something as simple as just making loads of stretchy bracelets out of these, triple-stranded or quadruple-stranded bracelets or necklaces out of this. And as Irene says, this time of year, oh my word, anyone, absolutely anyone could get away with wearing these kind of qualities. They really, really can. With gold, with silver, with rose gold, you choose. You are not limited at all with a bundle like this. Oh, just gorgeous. I love that. And you can tell it's a gemstone, can't you?
You can see it's classy straight away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And it just complements, and like you say, because it's got that shot, that sort of clarity going through it,
yeah,
it bounces off anything you're wearing.
Definitely.
That is
maybe
beautiful.
A twisted design, something, you know, you can really kind of zhuzh up the design with something like this, couldn't you? You can really have a really funky design. Because the gemstones are so simple, you can really go for it with the design there. Gorgeous. Well done, everyone. £12.95. Now, moving on now to, oh my word, this is absolutely extraordinary. I don't get the chance to bring you this gemstone often enough on Jewellery Maker. I'm constantly asking our management team upstairs for more of this gemstone. It's actually a very, very difficult gemstone to get hold of in a good quality. This is not just good quality. This is what I would describe as gem quality, worthy of silver, gold, platinum. And in fact, Sandra, one of our budding beaders, has made the most exceptional jewellery out of this strand. Oh my word, isn't that incredible? I've already got people adding this to their baskets now. Guest designers adding this to their baskets. Fleur's come through to get this all ready. Look at this in a ring. Oh my word. Oh my word. Look at it in earrings. Now, Citrine, you may or may not know, is a member of the quartz family. And members of the quartz family are really, really beautiful. They include gemstones like amethyst, citrine, smoky quartz, rose quartz. Generally speaking, quartz isn't known for its clarity. It tends to be known for its carat weight and its colour, and how popular it is, actually. With citrine especially, it is extremely difficult to bring you a high clarity quality gemstone. What I have here, it's a strand of citrine which reminds me of something. A few years ago, I was doing some research on the internet, looking at coloured gemstone collections that have been put together by some of the biggest jewellery institutes in the world. And one of them was Tiffany's. And I looked at Christian Dior as well, and I also looked at Bulgari. But the one that really stuck in my mind was Tiffany's. And Tiffany's have a collection of gemstone jewellery, some of which I've seen in London, in Selfridges and in their shop on New Bond Street. And the collection is made up of precious metal jewellery set with gemstones like blue topaz, amethyst, peridot and citrine. The citrine that they use in their designs, in my personal opinion, is of the same quality that we've got here. It is incredibly difficult to bring you citrine that is not only transparent, but I honestly cannot see a single inclusion in this strand. And that for citrine, I don't think I've ever been able to say that before. This is arguably the finest strand of citrine I have ever had on the show. Now, yes, arguably, faceting on a gemstone is going to detract from any inclusions that you might see. Yes, these gemstones have been faceted, but they're big, open, square and rectangular facets, so it allows you to see into the gemstone. So even though it is a faceted gemstone, you get to see right into the centre and the soul of the gemstone. I honestly cannot see a single inclusion in this strand. It's amazing. It's beyond eye clean. I reckon you'd have to get a jeweller's loop out to try and see any inclusions in this, because it is absolutely pristine. Fleur, guest designer Fleur, has texted in saying, "Morning, lovelies. I managed to get that strand of morganite yesterday after the show. I'm going to use this citrine with them. They are divine." Do you know what? Citrine and morganite together. Oh, my word, that sounds amazing. Oh, Fleur. Right, OK. Now, price point for this, you are not going to be able to believe your eyes with this. It is incredible. Check this out. Genuine citrine. I reckon some of the best, if not the best, we have ever bought you. My personal opinion, 50, 60, 70 pounds. Jewellery Maker price, £24.95. Oh my word, that is incredible. The amount of people coming through to get this strand is, it's hardly surprising. The quality you have got here is absolutely astonishing, and it's beyond gem quality for me. It's almost that kind of museum quality, the kind of jewellery that you see in a jeweller's window that they've got no intention of ever selling. It's just there to draw people into their jewellery shop. Pieces of jewellery that cost tens, if not hundreds of thousands of pounds, that no one's ever going to buy unless they've got a huge, huge, huge bank balance. But it's there in the window to entice people in. Honest, I mean, Irene, what do you think of this?
Well, straight away, you've said it's classy.
Yeah.
It's high head market product. I would expect to pay an absolute fortune for that. And it doesn't have to be. I also think it would look lovely with the gold findings as well.
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
But I just, that is very, very classy. Like you said, the cut is beautiful.
Isn't it?
And
just
every strand, it's from here, you can just see it glowing. That is hot, high-end market
jewellery.
Oh,
my word. This just reminds me, and it just shows you how much of an impression that jewellery made on me. It just reminds me of the jewellery that I saw on Tiffany's website and jewellery that I've seen in their shop window. This is kind of almost paralleling kind of canary yellow diamonds in my mind. But I don't mean radiated canary yellow diamonds. I mean like natural canary yellow diamonds, the kind of canary yellow diamonds that in a pair of earrings would cost you, oh, I don't know, in this kind of size, oh my word, I think you'd be lucky if you were able to get canary yellow diamonds of this kind of size for under six figures. You know, these are absolutely of that ilk and of that caliber. This really is some of the finest, if not the finest, citrine I've ever seen. It's absolutely beautiful. Absolutely amazing. I've had a text through saying, sorry, what? Will the sea beads take monofilament? Well, they'll definitely take monofilament, yes. Will they take beading thread?
Yes. Yeah.
I don't know. I should imagine so. Should we have a go? We can have a go if you want. Irene, can you see if you can get some beading thread through some of these sea beads? We've had someone text in about it.
Yeah.
Thanks, lovely. Well, they're on a temporary beading strand, which is really quite thick. We'll definitely be able to get them on Eslon and on monofilament. We're just going to double check to see if we can get them onto beading thread for you. Well done, everyone who's coming through to get this. It is absolutely the pinnacle of citrine. Isn't it? Wow. Absolutely sensational. Well done, everyone. Right. What are we doing, sorry? Oh, brilliant. Okay. Now, we've got a great deal here for turquoise coloured wire. Let's pop these pieces of jewellery down there. I tell you what, those pieces of jewellery, though, they look so expensive that Sandra's made. They're amazing. Can't help but make beautiful jewellery from a strand of citrine like that. Honestly, you can't. And I love Fleur's idea about putting it with the morganite that was on yesterday's show. That morganite was exceptional. That was gem quality morganite yesterday. Amazing. Right, okay, turquoise collection. I'm going to be honest with you, we did have a much, much, much larger quantity for this bundle today. Philip, had half the quantity of this bundle taken away. Why? Because we're not meant to be bundling together a wire like this. And because the price was really, really, well, the price is and was very, 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 very low. And our managers were a little bit worried about it. So, 10 metres of 0.4 millimetre gauge turquoise coloured copper wire, 10 metres of 0.6 millimetre gauge turquoise coloured copper wire, and 10 metres of 1 millimetre gauge turquoise coloured copper wire. The great thing about this bundle is you've got a 4, 6 and 1 mil gauge wire quality here, 10 metres in each. You can make all of your structured frames out of this spool here with your 1 mil gauge, any of your weaving and finer details are from these two here. Now, if you want to make jump rings or clasps, you can use your 0.6 millimeter gauge wire. This is going to be very low. It's going to go very, very quickly. $11.85 is the price point you should be paying. We're going low. This is the price point that the managers told Phil to do this at. Phil's a rebel, though. He's a rebel without a cause. The motto of the day is, stuff it, we're just going to go lower. $9.95, well done, everyone. That is absolutely... No! What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? No! What are you... You can't do that, Phil. You can't do that. You're not meant to do that. Phil, that is not the price point we discussed this morning. Phil is saying if everyone can buy this and it sells out, then there's going to be no evidence that it's going to be fine. Why do you do this to us? Why do producers do this? You say the price point, you say, yeah, before the show, yeah, we're going to do it at $9.95. Yeah, it's going to be great. Yeah, it's going to be awesome. Under a tenner for 30 metres of wire. Brilliant. And then they do that. It's like they sit in that producer's chair. The chair changes you, does it really? It's like when what? You are just, you're too much, Phil. That's ridiculous. That's sold out. Well done. Has it gone on to beading thread?
You've got.
Oh, yes. This is with regards to the seed beads and beading thread, regards to your text.
Yeah. You've got your wire.
Yeah.
You've got your nylon thread, it'll go.
Yeah.
And if you use your beading cord and you use a split fine sewing, it's called an eye pin. It's a needle that has a split so you don't have to thread it, and it's a really fine needle.
Ooh, lovely.
And because you're using 2 mil beads, this is the best type of needle I would use. And what you do, the pin just splits open, the needle rather. You put your cord through it. So I've got a beading cord, okay. Once it's closed, that's quite easy gone through for me there.
Ooh, so you can get monofilament through it.
Yep.
And beading thread?
Can get, yep.
Perfect.
And this one, yep. And that one. You tend, most, the fine beads tend to have that, I mean, I've just gone through about four or five there and they've all gone through very nicely. So I think you're going to be quite easy with that. But get yourself a lovely split fine needle to thread it through. Otherwise, you're going to have stronger glasses than I've got on.
Perfect. Awesome. Good to know. Sorry, it's a tissue. Just waiting to... Okay, right. So, okay. Brand new kit. I don't know about you, but I think this kit looks absolutely gorgeous just like that, don't you? Check it out.
Oh, I need to...
It really does, doesn't it? It looks beautiful just like that. The lace looks like rose petals, doesn't it? Don't you think? You're going to be getting lace, 10 pieces of lace in this kit, just like you did with the last kit. But it's red rather than silver. Absolutely gorgeous. It looks like they might be the same designs, actually. Absolutely glorious. Look at these pieces. They're wonderful, aren't they? This piece is really beautiful. Look at this. Oh! Love that one there. Detailing's absolutely exquisite on these. Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful rose designs that look great against the black as well, I think, don't they? Another V design there, beautiful. So 10 pieces of lace in total, gorgeous. You're then going to be getting, let's talk about the gemstones first. You're then going to be getting gorgeous gemstones. How about a double strand of garnet? This is absolutely incredible. Look how red this garnet is. That is what garnet should look like. That's what garnet should look like. Bright red in quality. Absolutely gorgeous. Beautiful clarity going through here as well. So not only are you going to be getting that gorgeous deep red colour, you're going to be getting that wonderful clarity, so you get what looks like a glass of red wine. Ooh, beautiful. Next, bronze colour coated pyrite rounds, which is absolutely fantastic. Because it's pyrite, they look and feel like metallic beads, because it's bronze coated. You could use it as a metallic bead if you wanted to. You don't have to use it as a gemstone bead. Look at it as a spacer if you like. They're wonderful, and that bronze goes so well with the garnet, doesn't it? It really gives it a, almost like a, it looks like an antiquity, doesn't it? Beautiful colour combination there, just gorgeous. You're then going to be getting another strand of garnet. One of the rarest varieties of garnet we have on Jewellery Maker, Hessianite garnet. This is totally natural. It's extremely rare. There's not much of this gemstone about at all on any one of our sister channels. And you've got this beautiful russet tone at the top going through these barley sugar colours and honey colours and amber colours. In fact, it works really beautifully with amber. I've seen it in the past with amber. It looks amazing. That is a beautiful combination, isn't it? Really, really striking. Great for this time of year. You're also going to be getting black pyrite, black colour-coated pyrite flat hearts. So beautiful. 6 to 10 millimetres in size. They're so angular. I love them. These are great in steampunk jewellery, great for your kind of industrial chic kind of jewellery as well, because they're really, really angular. They give you that lovely, lovely flash of metallic lustre there because of the coating and, of course, because this is beautiful pyrite. Now, I've got one final feature. So you've got all this gorgeous lace, 10 pieces of your beautiful lace, 4 strands of genuine gem, well, actually, the equivalent of 5 strands of genuine gemstones. And look at this. 20 metres of this. I love this stuff. Absolutely love it. This is the most wonderful, wonderful organza style ribbon. Now, you're going to be getting, and let me just double check, 20 metres of this designer ribbon. 20 metres in total. It's got the most wonderful width on it. Look how wide that is. Isn't that incredible? Oh, imagine making gloves out of that. Or fascinators. What Irene's done with this is simply beautiful. It really, really is. Absolutely gorgeous. It really makes a very exotic, very... really kind of, I don't know what it is, it's just such an exotic combination of gemstones, isn't it? It's just beautiful. With your Hessianite garnet, with your red garnet and your black pyrite and your bronze-coated pyrite and all this gorgeous lace. And then, of course, your beautiful designer eleganza ribbon as well. Stunning, stunning jewellery, stunning kit. Irene's put it with yellow gold-plated filings, which I think is absolutely the right thing to do. It just looks delicious. So exotic. Now, price point for this should be £52.65. Should be. How about we take off over £10? How about we take off over £20? Here's your deal today. You're going to love this. £31.95. Now again, like I said with the last kit, just for the gemstones on their own, that's pretty amazing, isn't it? £31.95 for natural Hessianite garnet, for a double strand of natural red garnet, for 2 strands of pyrite as well. That's pretty amazing, isn't it? Then, of course, you've got your 10 pieces of lace here, and you've got this 20-metre spool of eleganza web ribbon as well, which is absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. Really, really wonderful quality. Irene, beautiful, beautiful kit this one. So textural, isn't it?
It's absolutely classy. You've like you said, steampunk, Victorian.
Yeah.
Evening wear. It's just all round classic kit. Love it.
It's very kind of it reminds me of the kind of the Moulin Rouge as well,
yeah.
That kind of glamour, that kind of beautiful glamour. Mm. You know, those kind of beautiful ladies with the most wonderful curvaceous things.
Yeah.
It just makes me think of that. It's absolutely gorgeous, isn't it?
Yeah. When I seen it, I thought it was the wow factor, but I think with the black and the red together, it's absolutely stunning anyway.
Isn't it just? I mean, black and red together is such a gorgeous kind of sexy colour combination, isn't it? And it's just, it's just wonderful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I love the way that you've gone with yellow gold plated findings here. I think it works absolutely beautifully. I love this ribbon. It's incredible stuff, isn't it?
Mm. And like you say, you can cut it, and the depth of the collar and the reel that you've got, there's loads on it, absolutely loads.
20 metres. Yeah. That's going to last you such a long time. I love the fact you've cut the lace up here as well, because it just shows you those pieces can be standalone pieces, can't they? They really, really can be. With regards to the gemstones, I love what you've done with this Hessianite garnet. Did you know it was Hessianite garnet?
No.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
But I just thought it was such a beautiful cluster of them all together. Each stone is its own complementary. I didn't want to hide it. I wanted to make a feature of it.
Such a rarity, Hessianite garnet. It is such a rarity. That looks like a beautiful kind of Egyptian-style piece. I guess it looks a bit like a pyramid, doesn't it? It's beautiful. Love what you've done there. We're actually going to be seeing a technique on that in just... are we seeing a technique on this one?
Well, we can do, but I was going to show you the earrings, but I can quickly show you how to put those together anyway. It's not
a problem. We were going to see the earrings, weren't we?
Yeah.
But very quickly, you just used some head pins, didn't you?
Yeah, we did a top and bottom head pin. And as you know, we have some beautiful star head pins, don't we, that have got the nice head on them. Which I'm laughing to myself, because you were going, Irene really uses the gold and it looks lovely together, and then the demonstration I was going to do in silver. Just
it's
one
up
of
to
those
you.
Days.
Gorgeous.
But this is the two that I use. Obviously these ones that I've got here are a little bit more messier, but all I did there was I took the two head pins and cut top to bottom, and then I got some beautiful 0.4 gold gauge wire, enameled wire, and I keep looping it round and round and round, and that gave me the structure.
Yeah.
And then if you imagine both of those were the finished side pieces to make the base.
Lovely.
What I did then was I took the two ones and put them into a triangle, like you said, a pyramid.
Uh-huh.
And then I put another one in the centerpiece, so we had three. And in these, I just made a loop and jumped them over. Obviously, when you see the picture more close up, you'll see it. So they sort of made a feature.
Right. Yeah.
And then with the centre head pin, if I just grab another one.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretend that is there. Okay. And then all I did then was the top piece, I made some small jump ring, and that was my connection for the actual section to be put together later. And then all I did with these was I just added onto the 0.4 gauge reel, I added all the beautiful gemstones
of
my choice, and then I sort of figure eight wire wrapped all the way down until I finished.
Gorgeous!
And that was it.
Nice simple design, that one. Really, really lovely. I love the way you've used a red garnet as well with the yellow gold and the pyrite, the black pyrite with the yellow gold as well. I just think it's a lovely, it's a lovely, lovely combination. It's a really striking and rich and luxurious combination, isn't it? Just beautiful.
And this one here, what I did there was they're actually... you can wear it a few different ways.
Mm-hmm.
Literally, if you undo the clasp here and take it apart, it makes two necklaces. So this one would be... Yeah, it's sort of a holiday one, you know. If we took that apart now, then that would be a gold chain.
Yeah.
And then all you need to do then is fold our garnet, in half, where the loops are, and just thread the chain through these two sections here and bring them down and then hook them back together.
Awesome.
And then I just keep looping it over each other like that, and then brought it down, and then it made like a feature.
Lovely.
So you've got
great for your
two
capsule
necklaces
wardrobe.
In one.
Beautiful. Yeah. Now, with these earrings, let's just turn those around just like that. These are just so sweet. I love them. They're absolutely gorgeous. How did you make these, Irene? Show us.
They're lovely and easy, because that's my magic word, easy. Don't do difficult. I'm not very good at it. Right, here we go. So obviously this is the beautiful lace that we've got. And then as I play with it, I thought, well, if I fold it in half, it gives it more depth. And then I thought, well, what happens if I take a good length and chop it in half? I can make some beautiful earrings.
Gorgeous.
So that's what I did. I took two of those. Okay. And then what we did was we just chopped it in half. So the distance on that is 1, 2, 3, about 4 inches.
Okay.
Okay, it can be slightly, a bit less if you want to. And because of the amount of head pins that we're giving to our lovely customers at the moment, I just use one of the, I do really love the fine head pins.
The featherweight ones, yeah.
Yeah,
they're lovely.
Love those. And then all I did was I just folded it and just slightly overlapped it together. And I placed the head pin in my hand and I literally wire wrapped.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, and that just made a bow. And that was inspired really by those lovely little dainty girls with their hair,
headbands on.
Yeah, with the bows at the front.
They gorgeous.
Were almost like a Mickey Mouse look, you know, that was similar to what this looked like. It was really nice. And that sort of, you know, stuck in my thoughts. And then what I did was, that's the back.
Uh-huh.
That's the front. And then all I did again then was, as you can see, we've gone for the silver, not the gold. And then all I did was I took a nice head pin.
Uh-huh.
In fact, you know what, I didn't, because of the stone. Let's go back to what the lady was asking earlier. Beading thread, okay, mm-hmm. beading cord. And I just sewn in to the center point, sewn down again. Just to connect that beautiful little piece together.
Gorgeous.
Okay, and then just brought it so it roughly came to the center part here for me. There. This
lovely.
Lace is so beautiful to work with straight
yeah,
away.
Gorgeous.
I think the colors are the ones that help us, isn't it? The colors are so nice together.
They've done
half a job for us.
Uh-huh.
Right, okay, so what I did then was, I did that, but I took a closed jump ring. And can I just say, with a lot of jump rings, you can't do this because the closure of the jump rings are so badly done, this wouldn't work because of the fine thread I'm using.
Yeah.
But because we have really good jump rings, you find that you haven't got to worry about that coming apart.
Perfect.
Yeah,
good.
So I want my stone to actually stay in place, but mm-hmm. I need to do that first. So I'll go back down, she said. Because these needles are great, but they're a little bit sharp, so you need to be careful. But then I'm going to come back up, and the reason why I'm doing this is because if I don't, my jump ring will actually come over.
Ah.
Yeah, it will just fall off. So I need to connect that jump ring now to the centerpiece.
Uh-huh.
So all I'm going to do is just encase that and come over the jump ring now. Okay, and you can see. I mean, I've put mine on there. You could put it on after you've attached your stone. It's up to you. But you need to do that just a few little places around. Just to encase that together. So I've just done a few, but as you can see, that's just easy and it's there
gorgeous.
Now.
Gorgeous, that's beautiful.
Yeah. And it's tidy.
Mm.
So, you know, sometimes you look at the back of the work. I've got to think about looking at the back of the work as well.
Oh no, yeah, you've got to look at the workings.
Yeah, because actually finishing touches are important.
Yeah.
Scissors snipping off. However, what we can do, mine's a little bit tatty, I will snip that off again and go. What I will do as well is we've just got the end of the actual head pin now, so we'll just snip that off as well. We'll just take that off.
Lovely.
Yep, and that's that sorted. And then all we need to do then is attach a few jump rings, and we're just going to do the earrings. And you can add, so let me just quickly show you on this one. We just need to then, I added a jump ring here.
Yeah.
Okay, and then at the back of that, what I did then was I added some chain.
Yeah, that's a nice feature.
Yeah.
Lovely.
And then a head pin again. See how the fine head pins do go through these gemstones. Just made a loop and connected that to the chain.
Lovely.
And then this side, once again, I added a jump ring and attached it to a beautiful earring finding. And there we go.
Gorgeous.
Ta-da.
Thanks for that, Irene. They're really pretty. Beautiful. Well done, everyone. $31.95 for your gorgeous Sangria jewellery kit. Absolutely beautiful. We have got another yo-yo to bring you, actually, as well.
Mm.
Which, the first one was really, really, really popular. I've got the second one here, which is a round one, just like the last one. However, this one's larger. And I've got actually the exact shape, well, the exact shape, the exact size that this comes out at, which is this size here. This is quite a bit bigger, isn't it?
It comes out quite a bit bigger than the other one. All the way around, isn't it, from the other one?
Yeah. So you make a much, much, much larger piece of fabric from this. And also, what I didn't show you last time are the instructions. It does come with instructions. So if you do, if you are going to be getting this as a gift or you want to remind yourself on how to use it, then it does come with instructions as well. So I've got all the instructions here. It's absolutely fantastic. Okay. And that will come to you in a little pack just like that. So this is your yo-yo maker, the large one in exactly the same shape, so in that beautiful round shape. So you can make all these gorgeous pieces here, and that's the actual size you're going to be making there. And we did say that all the yo-yos today are going to be the same price. Here's your deal today, $6.95. I think that's amazing. Just gorgeous. And it's going to save you so much time as well, because I'm not really a seamstress. I don't have a huge amount of knowledge about sewing and how to finish pieces off, and my sewing wouldn't be to this kind of standard. Having a little gadget that makes even people who aren't into textiles good, able to make really professional looking pieces like this, it definitely gets my vote, yeah. doesn't it with you, Irene?
I think what you need to remember is that this is for all age brackets, and once you've purchased this, you've got it for life. But yeah, it's definitely for all age brackets. I mean, I've you know, from about the age of five, I think I've seen children having a go with their nan.
Yeah.
You know, I've gone to a lot of shows where there's lots of things going on. But the other thing with this is you're going to need this in your stash all the time, because it's a complimentary piece, not for jewellery, but for everything.
Absolutely.
Putting just little brooches on your bag. You know, just make a little brooch out of it, and it pops your handbag.
Or put little rosettes on the front of your ballet pumps and things like that. Like buying a plain pair of ballet pumps. They don't have to be too expensive at all. And then just get the fabric that you like, and you can make little interchangeable ones to clip onto your ballet pumps, depending on what colours you're wearing. You know, it doesn't have to be anything which you're going to be making into a huge, great big neckline piece or anything. It could be something as simple as making little charms for handbags or little charms to go on the front of shoes. And it's just a gorgeous, gorgeous little tool to use. And as Irene says, it's designed for all age brackets as well. So, you know, it's something which you can get your kids to have a go at too, although do watch them with a needle. Right, okay, awesome. Thanks for that, Irene.
You're welcome.
We'll go and have a look at some of your designs on the Wall of Fame. This is absolutely incredible. This is number 26. It's been made by Angela Humphreys. It says, this is my first attempt at wire work. This is her first attempt at wire work. I challenged myself to produce a greyhound, and it was very much trial and error. Though not perfect, I'm pleased with the result. I use Mukite, Tiger's Eye, and Black Onyx beads, all from Jewellery Maker. Angela, that's your first attempt at wire work. That is absolutely extraordinary. I can't believe you've done that. That is amazing. I love his tail. It's absolutely gorgeous, Angela. You've got such a talent there. Well done. Yeah. Best of luck. That is amazing. Oh, he's got a little thing on his collar as well. That's just amazing.
I can't even draw one like that.
Yeah. They don't make it out of wire. Angela, you're amazing.
I think we need to go round your house for some lessons.
We do.
And I've got number... This is also beautiful. Number 27. Okay, this is from Jane Millstone. Hope everyone is keeping well and enjoying the lovely weather. For my wolf, you call it Wolf's Wall of Fame, don't you? This week, I use my gorgeous green amethyst fascinated drops with the rose gold plated silver chain heart. And connecting together with 0.4 copper plated wire.
Beautiful.
To finish off, I use green ribbon, my type of girl, for the JM, of course. No time to chat, as my son is coming for tea and need to get organised with sweets and sour turkey.
Oh, sweet and sour turkey.
Really?
Wow.
Many thanks to all involved in the show, and good luck to my fellow wolfers in the draw.
Gorgeous.
Take care, bye, Jane Millstone.
Thanks, Jane. Sweet and sour turkey, that sounds nice. Mm. Number 28 here, beautiful colours here. Gorgeous from Colette in County Cork. Hi all, this is a labradorite necklace and bracelet. The labradorite chips and findings are from Jewellery Maker. The double drawer gems are from my stash. Best of luck everyone this week. Thanks for all the great deals, inspiration and entertainment. Regards, Colette. Isn't that beautiful? Gorgeous labradorite piece there. Awesome, best of luck.
I like that. Okay, we have number 29. Hi all, my entry this week is an agate slab. Botswana and Jasper, not a chunky necklace. I really like the asymmetric design. I can never say that word. Simple but effective. Good look to all. Mary Foros from Mansfield.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
It's absolutely gorgeous. That's the kind of piece you could wear all summer long. It's just gorgeous. You wear it with your linens. That's going to look amazing. Beautiful. I love Botswana agate. This is gorgeous. Number 30. I love the little elephant. From Ali. Didn't know what to do with my sapphire, so decided to make two bracelets with them and some sterling silver beads from my stash. Making pink ones next, and that's from Ali. Ali, that's gorgeous. I love the elephant as well. It's gorgeous. Right. We have emerald, ruby and sapphire coming up, which is absolutely astonishing. I've been a bit cheeky this morning because we had some strands similar to this over the weekend. I've actually bullied our managers into giving us one more strand because for a very, very special reason, which I'll explain a bit later on in the show. We've also got next week a Business Academy workshop with the gorgeous Angela Edwards. It's on the 29th, with the lovely Angela Edwards. She is such a talented lady. It's such an amazing workshop. There are a few spaces left on the workshop, and oh my word, it is well worth going on that workshop. If you can, it's on the 29th. Here's a few details about it.
Have you ever thought about making your jewellery making hobby into a business? Come and join our experienced jewellery maker and small business trainer, Angela Edwards, on a fun and relaxed day of tuition into the Jewellery Making Business Academy. Angela will teach you the basic business skills, including how to create a business plan, how to access current and potential customers. Angela will inform you how you should price your products to appeal to your customers and how to make it easier for you to sell to the right people at the right price. She will also teach you on how to use social networking to your advantage and gain a key knowledge on legal requirements and insurances. For more information, please contact our call centre on 0800 644 655.
Join Vicky Carr for her baby shower on Friday the 24th of April morning show. There'll be lots of fun, extra special JM treats, and Vicky will be joined by Angela, the JM Business Academy guru. It will be a morning show not to miss, Friday the 24th of April from 9 a.m.
Jewellery Maker course gift vouchers are now available. You can choose from a bronze, silver or gold voucher. Each voucher is worth a different amount that entitles you to put towards a course of your choice. For more information, contact our call centre on 0800 644 655.
When shopping with Jewellery Maker, you can add as many items to your order in one day and only pay one postage and packaging charge. We have two delivery options. Standard delivery at just £2.95 and you'll receive your parcel within 4 to 6 days. Or opt for our premium delivery at just £4.95 and you'll receive your parcel within 3 to 4 days. Happy shopping with Jewellery Maker.
Download the Jewellery Maker app today. You can watch our Jewellery Maker shows live, view all the details of the item that is currently on air, as well as browsing all the items from today's show. You can also minimise the video or switch to use as a companion app. Get the Jewellery Maker app today and boost your viewing experience. Jewellery Maker ships to the following countries. We offer two delivery services, standard and premium. So wherever you are in the world, Jewellery Maker are never far away.
Okay. Hi! Hi there, my hands. I've got some exciting news for you. I've got two mystery strands coming over from our vault right now, as we speak. So we'll be able to play those between now and the end of the show. They're very, very, very exciting. One gemstone I have never bought you on Jewellery Maker. The other strand I have bought you, but every single time we bring it to you, it sells out. Both of which are going to be amazing. I've got this gorgeous strand of sapphire, emerald and ruby coming up, which is beyond belief. I have been very, very cheeky this morning with this strand. I have, I hate to use the word bullied, but I have bullied our managers into giving me one more strand of this. We had strands like similar to this over the weekend, but this strand is coming up with a very, 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 very good reason as to why it's coming up, which I'll discuss with you a bit later on. Okay, so that's coming up. We've now got a little section. We've now got a little section of brand new ins. Now, we have our fifth birthday coming up over the first Maybank holiday. We have been, excuse me, we've been given the task by our managers upstairs to promote the birthday celebrations. It's my responsibility as a presenter to do that. It's all of our responsibility, but obviously you see me, I am the communicator of the channel. So it's up to all of the presenters here on Jewellery Maker that we make you aware of the birthday celebrations. The reason why we've been told by our managers that we have to promote the birthday celebrations is because it's our fifth birthday. And it's taking place over 5 days. 5 days! Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. I'm with you on the Saturday and Sunday. Lucy's Monday, Tuesday. Who's doing the Friday? I don't know who's doing the Friday. Might be Jenny. That'd be amazing. But I don't know who's with you on the Friday. I'm with you on the Saturday and Sunday. And Lucy's with you on the Monday and the Tuesday. It is going to be absolute mayhem. Pretty much all of our guest designers are involved. We're going to be launching an amazing DVD. But I'm sure you can understand we have to really, really, really promote that 5-day extravaganza for it to be a success for us and for you. So I've got a selection of birthday treats here. What we're doing with these is, these are all absolutely 100% brand new strands, and they're all going to go down to the kind of price points that you would hope to get strands at in a clearance deal, okay? They are all brand new. We're starting off with this. Now, we've already had, well, I've only shown it to you once. We've already had about 6 or 7 people texting about this strand, saying, when's it coming up? When's it coming up? It's coming up now. Okay. I didn't believe Phil this morning when he said that this was brand new. And I didn't believe him this morning when he told me the price point this is going to be taken down to. This is almost like a collection of cabochons, isn't it? On this strand, you're going to be getting 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Approximately 12 gemstones. This is all banded agate. Look how different they all are. You could use them like cabochons, couldn't you? Oh! Look at that, look at that! Look at that! Oh my word. Each one gives you a different look at that! Oh my word. It does look like the Grand Canyon. And the other side looks totally different. Oh my word, look at that. Gee whiz. Oh, look at this one here. It's like tortoiseshell. Oh, what? That looks like a totally different gemstone to that one there, doesn't it? It's all banded agate. Look at this one here. It's like a planet. I just love this strand. I absolutely love it. And the thick gemstones as well. Look at the thickness of them. Wowza. That one's beautiful. That's beautiful. Look at that one there with lovely smoky colours in there. Oh, I love the way it swirls. And look at the pin precision in there. The banding is amazing. And then that one there as well. So roughly 12 gemstones on this strand. Well, 12 gemstones on these strands that you're going to be getting. All of the gemstone strands I'm about to bring you are brand new. I didn't believe Phil this morning when he told me the price point this could be taken down to. Have a guess. 11 £11.95. £11.95p for this. £11.95p for this. If you're really lucky, yeah.
Yeah, and if you do that, you times that just by 10. Well, do you know?
Yeah.
40, but I was
40, 50
I
pounds.
Thought, I really thought if we were lucky, that would be about £30, you know, £29.95.
Oh, and that would be a jewellery maker price, wouldn't it?
Yeah. That's, they are beautiful. Honestly, they're really beautiful.
£11.95p. Can you imagine a bead shop, yeah, with a big, big tray of these and a sign above it saying two gemstone pendants for a tenner, because I can, even five for a tenner. You're getting approximately 12 on this strand for £11.95. That's less than a pound a pendant. Now the reason why we're doing these prices is because this little section is a pre-birthday treat selection for you, okay? So we're going to be bringing you some gorgeous, gorgeous strands, which are going to be pre-birthday treats for you. In fact, Tom, you might even have a slide thingy. We had it over the weekend. We were sent a slide down with pre-birthday treats on it. It was all a bit last minute. We were kind of told by the management team we were allowed to do pre-birthday treat prices on some of the deals that we had. We were kind of allocated some of them, then we made some of them up as well, because we just all stuff it. Let's just do it. This little section has been put together. It's all brand new. All of these strands are brand new, and they're all pre-birthday treat strands. Okay. The reason why we're taking these prices so low is because it is up to me. It's my responsibility to promote the living daylights out of the birthday show. It's starting on, now is it the 2nd? I need to know the date of it, don't I? It starts on the 2nd, doesn't it? Friday the 2nd, does that sound right?
I think it is.
Yeah, yeah. Friday the 2nd. 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th of May. 5-day celebration. It's just going to be absolutely ridiculous. We've got brand new tools, brand new gemstones. It's going to be amazing. You're going to see most of our guest designers. We're going to be doing double headers. We're going to have competitions. We're going to be giving things away. It's going to be mayhem, absolute mayhem. Okay. Which one are we doing now? Brilliant. Okay. Now, one of my favourite varieties of Jasper here, picture Jasper. I love this. Maybe it's because I'm a huge fan of Indiana Jones. I don't know. I went to the V&A Museum a couple of years ago to the Hollywood costume exhibition. And they had costumes in there from my favourite movies, like Dorothy's blue gingham dress from The Wizard of Oz. They had Marilyn Monroe's white dress from The Seven-Year Itch. They had Indiana Jones's hat, whip and outfit and shoes and boots from the Indiana Jones movies. I absolutely love Indiana Jones. I don't know what it is, I just love those movies. These remind me of Indiana Jones's maps. Do you see where I'm coming from, Mike?
Yeah, I do. I can sort of see the Indiana Jones
on. You can see the Indiana Jones in there. Kind of. Clutching at straws a bit, aren't I? I know. I can't actually see Harrison Ford in here, but I can see one of his maps.
The idea.
Indy!
I know what you mean.
Indy!
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Thanks, Irene!
That one there with the deep brown in it, definitely.
Yeah!
That looks like the main part where all the gold is.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yes!
That's the...
You see, she's on board now. I like this. She's backing me up.
I am always with you, hon, honest.
Either that or it looks a bit like cork as well. I love the fact these are faceted. We don't normally get faceted picture jasper. It's normally either... It's normally just highly polished rounds. These are lovely in a faceted quality. Okay. Are these going to go with the jasper cabochons that we had earlier on? Yes. Yes, the pebble jasper. Check it out. Lots of you make jewellery out of these kind of gemstones over the summer. Great kind of stony colours, which look fantastic with your linens, which look fantastic with your lighter fabrics, and your neutral tones that you tend to wear over the summer. Absolutely gorgeous. Whether it's kind of olive greens or whether it's gorgeous kind of cream and caramel colours. Right, so your picture... Always found it, there we go. So your picture jasper faceted pear drops. Amazing price point. Every gemstone is going to be totally unique. Every gemstone is totally natural. And here's your price point today for this brand new strand. All these strands are brand new, by the way. All of these strands are 100% brand new. $6.95. There you go. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Totally and utterly natural jasper there. Totally natural. If you want to multi-buy this, I'd definitely go for it, because every single one of these gemstones is going to be unique. Every single gem is unique. Every single strand is unique. Enjoy it. Get it. Enjoy it. I've got a couple of multi-bidders there as well, which is great to see. And it's nice that you've got them in this centered jewel drop style strand as well. Make lovely earrings, gorgeous tassels. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Well done. Loads of people with these in baskets. Please check those baskets out as quickly as you can. Aren't they gorgeous? $6.95 for your gorgeous strand of natural picture jasper. Brand new strand. Shouldn't have been $6.95, by the way. The reason why we're going so low is because it's a pre-birthday treat. Okay, we've been asked to put these kind of sections together to really, really heavily promote the birthday celebrations, which are coming up in less than 2 weeks' time, which I'm very excited about. Message coming in. Carol, please could you give out the email address to send photos for the Wall of Fame? Thank you. Yes. Wall of Fame at jewelrymaker.com. Studio at jewelrymaker.com. Yeah? Is that right? We're going to confirm with the slide, just in case Amelia's wrong. But we reckon. There we go. Send a photo of your design to studio at jewelrymaker.com. You are right, Amelia. There you go. That's the Wall of Fame. That's the Wall of Fame address there. Awesome. Oh, someone's sending in Wall of Fame entries. Maybe for the first time. Oh, nice. Brilliant. Well done. Okay, so that is very, very popular. So I'm going to have a swig of orange juice. I woke up yesterday with a cold. With a really annoying cold. And do you know why? Oh, sorry, I'll move that away because it's branded. Do you know why I've got a cold? This is so weird. So before Christmas, I had a really bad bout of sinusitis. And I had to have antibiotics and all that kind of stuff, which when you're pregnant isn't ideal, but it was the only thing that kind of helped. I then started taking pregnancy multivitamins, and it was like a light switch. 2 days later, I felt great. Absolutely awesome. I tidied, trying to be really efficient, tidied away my pregnancy multivitamins a week ago. I haven't been taking them for a week, and I've got this now.
Oh.
You see? You need your vitamins when you're pregnant.
So, can't I find out what's in your vitamins then?
What's that, Lovie?
Because I've had the sniffles and a bit of a cold since Christmas.
Take your multivitamins.
Well. Yeah.
Take your multivitamins, Irene. It's so important.
Yeah, is it vitamin C? A bit of orange. I think that's what you should take.
Iron as well. Iron's a really good one to take. Because it stops you from feeling tired.
Oh, I'll have some of that then.
Oh yeah, some iron.
I'll have a bit of that.
Gorgeous. Anyway, right, next. Now, you are not going to be able to believe the deal we're doing for this. I sat down with Phil and said this morning, what's in this section? He showed me the gemstone strands that were in this section. He then told me the price points of each one. The agate, I couldn't believe. The picture jasper, I thought, yeah, that's going to go. This next strand, I honestly look at this strand, there is no way. Oh, it has been seen before. Okay, so this, I do beg your pardon, this one has been seen before. Seriously, I love it. This strand, the first time it was shown, I thought they were all new, but apparently this one has been shown. So Phil lied to me, basically.
Oh.
Makes me look all right, Wally. Anyway, so the first time this strand was ever on air, it sold out in 1 minute.
Wow.
And it's been reordered. I'm not surprised in the slightest. Genuine, natural, 8mm rounds of sunstone. This comes from one of the leading locations for sunstone in the world, from Norway. It comes from underneath a glacier. Underneath a glacier. Yes, in Norway. Were you listening, Phil? I don't know. It comes from underneath a glacier. Did you watch Fortitude? You can drill underneath glaciers. So, 8mm rounds of sunstone from Norway. Arguably the best location in the world. Mm. just humour me. What kind of price do you reckon this is going to go down to? What kind of price has been your experience of sunstone? $19.95 maybe? Mm. Maybe $17.95 if it's a pre-birthday treat. That would be amazing, wouldn't it?
That would be very nice.
What do you reckon, Irene?
I was going to say the $19.95. But the quality of them stones are gorgeous.
Yeah, so it could be
and
even more.
Round. Yeah, and people love that shape because it tends to be able to easily work with, isn't it? So I would go $19.95.
Perfect, $19.95.
Yeah.
$6.95.
No. Somebody's gonna have a headache.
I almost spat my yogurt and blueberries out this morning when Phil told me it was £6.95. He was like, you were like a child on Christmas morning with this stone. He said, I got this. Guess what price it's gonna be? He doesn't actually sound like that, but he said, guess what price this is gonna be? $6.95, Carol. What? Honestly, this is this is ridiculous. It is utterly, utterly ridiculous. That was a rubbish impression of Phil, by the way. It doesn't sound anything like that at all. I look at a strand like this, I look at a price like that, and now I can understand why the first time this strand was ever on air, it sold out in under a minute. It looks like this one might be the same exactly. Exactly the same. I'm not surprised. So many people there. Well over 2/3 of the stock has been allocated there. Well done, everyone. I don't think anyone can actually believe that. Well, there's so many people multi-buying this. Yeah. Well done. It's unbelievable, isn't it? $6.95 for sunstone of that.
You got three for the price we just said.
I know. Right. This next strand is new. Now, have a look at this. Oh, mamma mia. Mamma mia. This is grey moonstone. Oh my word, look at the shiller coming off that. With grey moonstone, you're not gonna be getting a rainbow quality. You're gonna get rainbow quality from rainbow moonstone. With grey moonstone, you're going to be getting a white and silvery grey shiller. Oh, that is exceptional. It's natural as well. Absolutely 100% natural. Oh, wow, so look at that one there. Cor blimey. Wow. That is some of the best grey moonstone I think we've ever had. Some of it's actually almost cat's eye. That is absolutely... Some of this has almost got asterism in it. It's absolutely incredible. Grey moonstone. That is some of the best grey moonstone I've ever bought you. Now, this with the sunstone that we just bought you. Oh, that's great together. That is great. Really vintage. Really, really beautiful. Oh, yeah. $6.95 for this. Obviously, with the grey moonstone. You know, these are larger gemstones. They're 10 millimetres in size. They're 10 metres in size. 10 metres. 10 millimetres in size. You're going to be getting a much, much, much larger gemstone. This is some of the best grey moonstone I think I've ever bought you. So this is going to be... Okay, so this is going to be more like your $19.95, yeah? 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 No? 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 The reason why we're taking these prices so low, these are pre-birthday treats. We've only got one more strand after this. which is going to be, oh my word, £12.95 for like the ultimate strand of grey moonstone. Isn't it just gorgeous? Isn't it amazing? I've got, oh wow, loads of people coming through to get this. Well done. It doesn't surprise me at all. Not when we've got quality like this at £12.95 with the amount of shiller coming off this as there is. And I'll get it off this black mat just so you can see the exact colour of it. So I was being lazy there rolling it on that mat. The most beautiful, look at that. Look at that, against the skin. That looks amazing. That kind of vintage lace kind of quality, don't you think, Irene? It's so soft, it's like a dove grey, isn't it? It's beautiful.
It is, but I'm just thinking, you imagine it if you've got some beautiful, bright pearl stones in there.
Oh,
you know,
definitely.
Like the luminant colours.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Know, like the oranges and yellows and the reds.
Nice.
And
yeah.
They'd be really nice in between that.
Definitely with pearls. I'd never thought of it with like bright,
yeah,
bright colours. But yeah,
like
that would work,
colours.
Wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Because it would make those colours pop even more, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Ooh, and you might even find that the moonstone might pick up on some of those bright colours and it might kind of effectively be taken in and kind of, not physically, but kind of soaked in by the moonstone. That's beautiful. $12.95. Lots of multi-bidders for this. Lots of multi-bidders. That is amazing quality. Just beautiful. Well done, everyone. Under £13 for that gorgeous grey moonstone strand. Okay, final one. Like I say, the reason why we're taking these prices so low for all of these incredible strands is purely because these are pre-birthday treats. Okay, our birthday show is on these. It starts on the 2nd of May and goes on for 5 days. The Friday, the Saturday, Sunday, the Monday, the Tuesday. I'm with you on the Saturday and Sunday. Lucy's with you on the Monday and the Tuesday. I don't know who's with you on the Friday. It'll be someone amazing, I'm sure. We've got loads of great guest designers coming up. We've got loads of great launches, DVD launches, gemstone launches, findings packs, loads of incredible tools. It's just going to be an absolutely electrifying 5 days on Jewellery Maker. It's going to be madness. Right, coming up now, Dalmatian Jasper. No dogs were harmed in the making of this strand. Do you know where Dalmatians come from, anyone? Dalmatia. The Dalmatian coast in Croatia. Yeah.
That's the one thing I remember, you know, as a child. Because my dad died when I was 3. And I remember we had a Dalmatian dog.
Yeah.
And obviously only being so little, he used to come running at me. And you know when you used to go... And I remember that dog, and it's really weird. So that's a nice strand for me to buy for memory, yeah.
Yes.
That this dog attacked me. But he was a lovely dog. I did like him. He was beautiful. But I just thought I'd share that with you. I don't know why.
This reminds me of a book I read with Hattie about dogs, Harry McClary. And one of the dogs is called Bottomley Potts, all covered in spots. And he's a Dalmatian.
Oh.
Reminds me of Bottomley Potts. It's gorgeous. Totally natural, absolutely gorgeous. You can see why it's called Dalmatian Jasper, can't you? If you can't, then goodness me, you need to look up a picture of a Dalmatian, basically. Here is your gorgeous strand of Dalmatian Jasper. They're all beautiful puffy hearts. I love, love, love this quality. It is entirely natural. Here's your price point today for your 230 carat of Dalmatian Jasper. John and Janet have come through to get 4 strands. Well done. I've got lots of multi-bidders here. Oh, wow, loads of people coming through for this. Well done. It's $6.95. I'm not surprised. It's $6.95. Mm. And what you were saying earlier on, Irene, about kind of heart-shaped and coin-shaped gemstones is you can just make really simple, lovely little earrings out of something like this, can't you?
Yeah. And like we did with the bracelet earlier, just use it as a drop charm.
Yes,
or,
lovely.
Again, at the back of the necklace. So you've got a feature at the back of the necklace when you're wearing it.
Beautiful. Yeah, definitely. It doesn't necessarily need to be, you don't necessarily need to use lots and lots and lots of it in one go. Just one as a little charm or a couple in a pair of earrings. The designs can be really, really nice and simple. $6.95 for Dalmatian Jasper, though. Just gorgeous. And what will I put this with that I've got today? Oh, goodness me. Loads. With the moonstone. With the sunstone. Yeah. With the gorgeous cabochons. Gorgeous. Well done, everyone. We've had a text through from Marilyn. You could call them puppy hearts.
Oh. I like that.
Dreadful. Marilyn, do not encourage Phil. He said, oh, that's a good one. He's just written that down.
I was just going to say, is he writing them all down?
Hey?
I was just going to say, is he writing them all down?
Yeah, he's writing down all these puns that people are sending in. He's going to use them. He's going to steal your ideas, everyone, just so you know. Phil loves a pun. So well done, everyone. So those are your pre-birthday treats. So please make sure that you are watching the birthday show spectacular, which is taking place over 5 days from the 2nd of May. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It's going to be absolutely spectacular. It's going to be amazing. We are making you aware of the birthday by doing these birthday treats, basically. However, I've got this strand coming up later on. That it's not a birthday treat, but it's like my treat to you. It's coming up in about half an hour's time, and it's this emerald, ruby, and sapphire. I have been a little bit naughty this morning asking for this strand. We weren't meant to have it on today's show, but I thought, stuff it, if you don't ask, you don't get. There is a very good reason for me bringing you this strand on today's show. It's coming up in about 25 minutes time, and I'll tell you what my extenuating circumstances are in about 25 minutes time. Okay. Blimey. Go one or two ways, that one. Ooh! I'm either going to have a job or I'm not at the end of the show. Right, okay, so coral now. Orange coral tubes. I like the look of these. I love the feel of coral, don't you?
See, that'd go nice when we talked about luminous colours.
Ah, so with the moonstone. Ah. Mm. She's right. There's a reason why Irene is a guest designer. No, it does. It goes. That's beautiful.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really nice. I like that.
I love dyed coral, Irene. I love it. This is fossilised coral, just so you know. We haven't gone to the Great Barrier Reef and dredged it and kind of killed all the coral. This is all fossilised coral. So this coral is absolutely fine to be used in genuine gemstone jewellery to be dyed because it is already fossilised. So with coral, when you dye coral, it takes the dye in a really interesting way. Coral, as you know, is a living being, and it is made up of hundreds and thousands and millions of tiny little kind of spongy-like qualities which soak up minerals and elements from the seawater. When we dye coral, you get to see all those tiny little pores, you get to see all those tiny little inclusions, and this is what I love so much about dyed coral. Unlike any other gemstone, you have this amazing fingerprint almost going through this gem. Now, these are orange coral tubes. They're 10 by 8 millimetres in diameter. Absolutely gorgeous quality. The Romans believed that this had magical and medical properties. Amazing, isn't it? It is only myth and legend at the end of the day, but, you know, it's a great way of looking at a gemstone, isn't it? Just to kind of take that myth and legend on board. Also, you've got, basically, you're looking at a snapshot of life millions of years ago. Isn't that incredible? It's like when you look at amber, you're looking at something which has been frozen in time, just like coral. You look at something which has happened millions and millions and millions of years ago. This is all the way from Indonesia, which is just incredible, isn't it? Okay. Great price for this. Just to let you know, the deal you can see on our website at the minute isn't your price. Even though we've got loads of people checking the baskets out and confirming, this is your price. £7.95. Wow, I've had loads of people multi-buying. I wonder if anyone who's come through to get two of these is now going to add three of these to their order, because it's now £7.95 and not £10.95. Well done. Orange coral tubes, 10 by 8 millimetres in diameter. Lovely size and shape on these, don't you think, Irene?
I love the shape of those.
Really, what would you do with these? What kind of designs do you think they lend themselves to?
Well, I think just what you said was about mixing the two gemstones together. I like the idea of the shape of that, and I think because it looks oblongated, I would go for a long necklace, and I think I'd have it randomly with a nice chain in between, a few of those dropping in between with open jump rings as well. I think I'd have a bit of chain mail. I think I'd have a bit of the coral, and then I would have a chain as my main neck, but I would do a teardrop of a few of those randomly at the base.
Nice.
Yeah, because I like that, and I don't think you need all of them. I would probably use about 3, 6, 9, probably 10 maximum, and that would be it.
The great thing about something like coral is as well, because it's an organic gem, you'll find that it will work in kind of layered and kind of beach jewellery as well. And the reason why it works in beach jewellery is because it physically comes from that part of the world.
Yeah.
And you quite often find that shell works in beach jewellery, not because of any other reason other than the fact that you find shells on the beach and they're very at home there, as these will be. I love that idea of making a lovely kind of long, maybe even kind of like a lariat style necklace out of something like this. The shape of the gem really does lend itself to that kind of drop, doesn't it?
But that goes really well with cording as well, the cord that we've got on the show today.
Definitely.
Goes really nice with that,
also like the waxed cord and things like that.
Because Native American type, you see, that and turquoise stones look beautiful together, doesn't it?
Definitely. This actually, with some of the I mean, with the natural turquoise, it would look great, but you know the reconstituted turquoise that we do that's that really bright, vivid turquoise colour? It would work really well with that.
Really
and
nice.
It would give that kind of Native American quality, wouldn't
it? An alternate as a necklace, probably a short necklace, and then make probably, you know, use one of our bezels or a beautiful, nice big gemstones as a feature.
Yeah, lovely. Gorgeous.
Really nice.
Well done, everyone. Lots of people still coming through for that. Well done. And it's $7.95. What a strand. Love that.
I like that.
Okay. Sorry. What? Which box? Ooh. Sorry about me coughing today. I'm ever so sorry. Cannot be helped. I'm sure it probably could be.
Oh, I think you're doing extremely well.
Thanks, Irene.
There you are.
Wow, soldiering on. You got to, haven't you? It's hardly hard work sitting here and talking about amazing gemstones, is it? It's not really like working. Just sitting here having a chat, basically. That's what I love about this job. Make everyone think that you're working really hard, and actually you're just sitting here having a chat. It's nice, isn't it? Don't tell anyone I said that, but yeah. Right, eye pins. Here we go. Eye pin essentials. Now, eye pins. What? Believe me when I say I have been badgering our management team and our buying team to get more eye pins in stock. With our findings packs here on Jewellery Maker, we don't tend to stock eye pins in our findings packs. We tend to give you them in packs like this, which, do you know what? At the end of the day, you're still getting eye pins, which is great. It would be lovely to see more of them in the ready-made finding packs, I agree. But we can still bring you eye pins. If we weren't able to bring you eye pins, then yes, we would have a problem on our hands. But we can still bring you eye pins. The great thing about this bundle is you're going to be getting yellow gold, rose gold, and silver plated copper eye pins. They are all 40 millimetres in length. Oh, no, actually, sorry, the rose gold ones are 38 millimetres in length. you're going to be getting 100 in each. Let me show you these. They've got a lovely 3mm eye in them, which is a really big eye to have on an eye pin, which is brilliant. You can make a lovely chain out of these. Here's an example of the yellow gold plated copper one. See the size of the eye? Aye, aye. It's great, aye, isn't aye. It?
That's me. Aye, aye.
Aye, aye. Here is an example of the silver one. Again, lovely big 3mm eye on that. Both of these are 40mm in length, so you could, essentially, if you wanted to, make two eye pins out of one, because they are nice and long. Okay, and you're also going to be getting these rose gold plated ones, which are 38mm in length, so slightly smaller, as you can see. And a little, slightly smaller eye on these, I think, by the look of it. Maybe about a 2mm eye on these. So, 300 eye pins in total. You're going to be able to make so many wonderful pieces with this. Lots and lots of people use eye pins to make their own chain, to make their own tassels, to make their own dangles. And it's lovely to have that ready-made quality. £8.95 for, excuse me, 300 individual eye pins. 100 rose gold plated copper, 100 yellow gold plated copper, and 100 silver plated copper. What I love so much about these, Irene, is that you can mix them up. I love mixing up that precious metal quality. I never used to do it, but since I've seen guest designers do it, I thought, you know what, there's nothing to be frightened of mixing up gold, rose gold, and silver. It looks, it can look really expensive, can't it? Really kind of couture.
Yeah, you can wear it with anything then, can't you? Because you've got the three tones.
Yeah, definitely.
But I like the idea of all those eye pins, because what I would be doing is I'd coil each one of those, keeping the loop on the one end, make another loop on the other end, and I would do like a chain mail, you know, a coil chain connection
nice
for
idea.
A necklace.
Yeah.
And then you could even thread a bit of cord through that loop, the coil that you've done.
You could do, but I love your idea. Because they're 40mm and 38mm in length, you do have the option to do that.
Yeah.
You know, you've got that extra little bit of wire to work with, because you're not really going to be working with gemstones. Well, you might be, but in 9 out of 10 cases, you won't be working with gemstones which are going to take up the entirety of the eye pin. So you can do that little coiled effect that Irene's discussing. Because these eye pins are nice and long, loads of people multi-buying these. I would advise you do multi-buy these, because I don't know from one day to the next when we're going to get eye pins back in stock. I constantly get messages from Jewellery Maker viewers, because I am very open and honest. I say, look, if there's anything that we don't stock on Jewellery Maker that you're having to get elsewhere, please let me know. Either email me, but I don't know my email address. What is it? It's carol at tggc.com, because there's another lady called Carol who works in the warehouse and she gets my emails sometimes. I think it's carol@jewellerymaker.com. carol@gems.tv. Carol without the E, C-A-R-O-L-R, at gems.tv, or go to my Facebook page, which is Carol, C-A-R-O-L, Roache, which is R-O-A-C-H-E, weird Irish surname. It's weird. Apparently it means to live under a rock, which is nice. So go to my Facebook page, and let me know if there's anything that you get elsewhere which you can't get from Jewellery Maker. Eye pins, I get most messages about eye pins, saying, please get some more eye pins in stock. So get them now. Well done, everyone. Gorgeous. Right. You know how you can get family crests and things like that? Apparently, my dad found that we'd had not like a crest, nothing as kind of as up there as that, but apparently it's something like a serpent under a rock. Something to do with rocks, my maiden name. My married name's McGurk, which is even more Irish. Anyway, I don't know. Right, okay, Kit. Da 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 da. Sometimes the sun goes round the moon. Just when I thought our turns had passed, you went and saved the best for last.
Beautiful.
Thanks, Irene.
All right, love.
Thanks, love. Am I allowed to say that? Can I say that? We saved the best to last. I'm just going to say it, stuff it, I don't care. We've saved the best to last. This is an absolute beauty of a kit. I don't know who Irene's had to bribe to get this kit. It's absolutely gorgeous. You're getting the full kit and caboodle here. The whole shebang. Oh, my word. Oh, I'm going to save that strand to last. That is the labradorite.
I know,
which strand am I saving to last? Really got a giggly pants on today, as our Irene.
Oh no, I've got to stop this, haven't I?
You do.
I keep chuckling at you.
Sound like you've got a secret or something, yeah. Or you're doing something naughty over there.
Yeah, but you make me laugh. I'll just chuckle away.
It's
I'm
like
happy.
A 10-year-old's laugh.
Right, I'll stop then. I'll be right
at
grumpy.
Your age. No.
All your shoe
your
size.
Age. No, never act your age.
They're all in five, so it doesn't really matter no more.
You got size 5 feet?
Yeah.
Small little feet.
Yeah.
Right, okay. So here we go. Moonstone wheels. Absolutely gorgeous. Faceted wheels of moonstone. This is a gorgeous rainbow quality. We're going to be getting beautiful blue shimmer going through these. These are really quite big, aren't they? They're really big. How big are these? Did it say? Fat wheels. 3x2 to 4x3. Philip's calling these big fat wheels. Thanks for that, Phil. You're also going to be getting amethyst rounds, 2 to 4 millimeters in size. Oh yeah, gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. A beautiful clarity on these as well, don't you think? Absolutely gorgeous. Third and final strand, labradorite. Now, oh my word, this is described shimmer lacquer coated labradorite. I have never seen this in my life. All I know is our buying team upstairs, and I know both Hannah and James are in today, so two members of our buying team. We need more of this. Yeah, I've never bought this to you before, ever. Claire, who's over, says, I don't even know what you're talking about, Carol. Shimmer lacquer coated labradorite. Are you ready to see this? Oh!
The wow factor, hasn't it?
Oh my word. It looks like the strands of diamonds that we've had in over the last few months. Gee whiz, that's beautiful. Oh my goodness gracious me, isn't that beautiful? Absolutely astonishing quality. Bracelet. Look at that, Irene. Just something as simple as that.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, it's actually, you. Oh, yeah. We're going to see an awesome demo from Irene where she's going to be using this in a bracelet in a few moments. And it's just, it is absolutely gorgeous. Something as simple as this, though. Now, there's loads of extras. I've got to crack on with this kit. Sorry, there's loads of extras. You've got your threading pack with monofilament beading thread and elastic, which is great. There it is. You've got a silver plated copper findings pack as well, where you're getting 100 silver plated copper findings, which include things like a meter of chain. This is one finding, by the way, this meter of chain. One finding, that counts as one. It's amazing. One finding here, and 99 other findings, including heart top head pins. What else? Three different varieties of head pins, actually. Ribbon ends with, what do you call them? Ribbon ends with extender chains and an S-hook clasp on there. S-hook 7. You're also going to be getting these beautiful heart-shaped spacer beads, which I, when I first saw this findings pack, I didn't actually believe that these were part of the findings pack. I thought they were extras. They are actually part of the findings pack. 10 of these in total. Pick one of them up. They are beautiful brushed heart. Oh, such an idiot. Here we go. Oh, come here. I'm like trying to use chopsticks. Concentration. There we go. So you've got your gorgeous brushed quality of silver-plated copper heart-shaped beads here. They're wonderful, aren't they? 10 of those, okay? Gorgeous, aren't they? You're also going to be getting this wonderful heart-shaped toggle clasp as well. There's really interesting earring findings, crimp bead covers. You're going to be getting jump rings as well, more S hooks. There's loads of great findings here. You're also going to be getting a matrix box, a mini matrix box. I know, it's unbelievable. Mini matrix box includes four of your ribbon ends with extender chains. This is all silver plated copper, two toggle clasps, jump rings and chain as well. It all comes to you in this gorgeous little box here. And believe it or not, there's even more. Because you're also going to be getting black pendant cord. This stuff is amazing. It's ready braided. It's 3mm in size. Let me see if I can kind of peel some of this off actually so you can see just the beautiful braid quality. Okay, so you're going to be getting how much of this? 10 metres of your pendant braid. Surely that's it. Surely that's it. No, there's more. I know. 10 metres of purple pendant braid as well. That is absolutely incredible. So, some of the most amazing brand new cord that we've had in stock in ages. You've also got 100 silver plated copper findings. You've also got your silver plated copper findings, sort of matrix box here. Three strands of gemstones, including your moonstone, your amethyst, and some of the best labradorite I've ever seen in my entire life. Plus, you've got your threading pack with monofilament beading thread and elastic. I love it. Your original price, £47.10. Not today. We're going low. We're going low, low buffalo. How about we go really, really low? How do you fancy a price point that's under £35? How about £29.95? Yeah, amazing, isn't it? £29.95. I know some people that would pay £29.95 for that labradorite on its own. Oh my word. That is absolutely extraordinary, isn't it? Oh wow. Wow. That labradorite is absolutely... That is worth every single penny of £29.95. I love that. It's got almost like a snowy quality to it, hasn't it?
It is high spec. It is... Just oh, on its own, it talks class and beauty.
Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely sensational quality. Irene, I'm coming over.
Okay.
Okay.
Okie dokie.
Beautiful big kit, this one. What did you enjoy most about working with this kit? Just whilst I blow my nose again.
Well, I've got to be honest, I'm really impressed with the cord. I like the quality. I like the way that it's woven. I've taken a good few meters out from it and it has not even showed any discolour, any faults. It is really woven well and it was an absolute pleasure to work with. Probably the nicest one I've seen. I love the labradorite, like you said. That, you know, I've mixed all the mediums together and I think they all flow really, really well together. I think it's a very classy, good quality kit. I've really enjoyed this one. I really have enjoyed it.
I think you're right. I think mixing up the mediums, mixing up the different textures, you're only going to make this kit look even better. This pendant cord, which I know you've really enjoyed working with, there is so much you can do with it. Just talk us through this braid. What braid is this, Irene? This is gorgeous.
It's done by hand. It's just a looping process, and I've also done it with the Hessian beforehand.
Ah, lovely. Okay.
Yeah. So I can show you that quite easy. It's very quick, but it's effective, and it really does give a wow factor, I think, to it.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I really like that one.
Look at this.
And then I love the idea, because of all the delicate stones that we're getting in now, you know, sort of, I think they're a 4 mil. That's the amethyst, isn't it?
Yes, between 2 and 4 mil.
Yeah. And then I just coiled that round, you know, probably coiling gizmo machine have, or even I've done it on a large double-ended pin needle.
Perfect.
And then I've coiled it, added them on first, then coiled over it. And just use those as the feature, which I think is quite classy.
Oh, it's beautiful. So you get a lovely spiral of amethyst there, which looks absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, I like that one. I
beautiful.
Like that. And obviously the chain, the findings in here, you know, if you think that you're going anywhere, you know, you need in your tool bag and you need to quickly go, buy this kit because it's got everything you need.
Yeah, it really does.
It's got it all there, you know, everything you need to use, whether it's, you know, jump rings, chain, head pins, you know, little features, like you said, with the hearts in there.
Beautiful,
I thought they were separate, but no, they're not. They're gorgeous.
This is a lovely braid as well. I like what you've done here. And that's just simply looping the cord, isn't it?
Yeah, just loop it. And then once again, I used the head pins. Mm-hmm. And what I did then was I just coiled it around at this section here just to keep the cord connected together.
Yeah, lovely.
Then I made a jump ring and I added a feature of one of the head pins onto the jump ring.
Perfect. Now we're going to be seeing a technique on this bracelet here, which is this astonishing labradorite. It is absolutely beautiful. It's got this lovely shiller lacquer on it, so you get this incredible glow, this beautiful, oh, almost like a snowy moonstone quality to the labradorite, which just looks amazing. And you've done this beautiful pair of earrings as well, which looks just gorgeous.
Yeah. Well, I've just made one, that's how quick it is.
Oh, gorgeous, awesome.
Yeah. And then what I thought I could do is show you how to make the other one, because it's the same technique.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's go. Okay, right, what we got then is we're going to use our lovely beading cord. Yeah?
Yep.
Okay. And what we're going to do then is we're going to take some of these beautiful labradorite. And what we're going to do is, if I just show you actually on here, what I want to do is I want to show you how to start off and how to finish. And what we've done is I've used the actual thread to make my jump ring. Okay, so let me get over here for you. Let me move some of this because I'm making a mess.
That's
I'm in a messy
right,
mood today, you know. Some days you get tidy days. Today I'm all bitty, so I do apologise. But what we're going to do today is we're going to show you how to make the beginning section, and it's all about using your crimps as well, because some people are not always very good at using their crimps, and I don't want you to be scared of it. So I'm going to take a crimp. And the length of the strand that I've got is just probably the width of my board. Okay, that's all. And I'm just going to make an earring, because obviously you don't want to watch me do the whole lot.
Yep.
So put that into the centre area. And all you do then is take a tail and then go back through forming a loop. Okay, so equal rough length of your strand. So what we're doing is we're forming a little loop. Okay. And then what we're going to do is you're going to take your crimpers, and what we're going to do is we're going to place that inside so it comes to the back notch on the crimper.
Lovely.
Right, and I'm going to pull it down just till I can get as much as close as I can for that. If you want to squish your crimps, you can, but I'm not a squisher really. I'm not really that way in wanting to do that. There are times when you need to do that, and that is usually when you do like a random necklace of some sort. But this one, what I want to do is I want to give it some more shape. So first of all, squeeze it there, and that then gives you your, what you call your little C-section. Okay, and it comes a bit like two little loops. Then what we do then is we come to the further outer side, and then that final end of the crimps, we're going to squash it then, and that gives it a nice smooth around section. And then all we need to do then...
Please don't call it a C-section. Please don't.
Sorry.
That's all right. Dear.
Yeah, I'm usually quite good with words.
The whole team just went, oh!
Yeah, you don't want that.
No. Blimey.
It's just one of them days.
I know.
I caught my finger in the door and ripped half of my nail off this morning.
Have you? Only my ball.
Yeah, but don't worry, they're getting done.
So. Okay.
But, you know.
So your lab dryer's gone on. How many of your lab dryers have you used on there, Irene?
For the actual bracelet, I did 8 on either side.
Okay.
But for the earring, I didn't want it to be that large a loop. Mm. You can go down to probably 3. You could go down to 3 stones if you wanted to. Okay, so the loops aren't as big, so you decide. Uh-huh. But I've got 3 on the right, and now I'm going to 4 on the right. I'm going to have. Let me try and go. I'm really conscious about that nail. I do apologise.
Oh, don't worry about it. Honestly, it's fine.
Oh, I hate it when my.
Hadn't even noticed.
Oh, promise. Well. Promise. You know. Thank you anyway. Right, last one. It does go through. Let me try another one. Okay, so we have 4 on either side.
Okay, yeah, lovely.
Then all we need to do to make our loop is we take a crimp to the right, take the left through, pull it down, and that makes our first loop. Okay.
Uh-huh.
There we go. Okay, so that makes our first loop. Then what we want to do then is just once again go to the first, which one is the nearest to the actual handles, and squish. Bring it out to the second loop, hold it together, and squeeze. And that gives us a nice, closes it in for us, okay? And it stops it being rough to wear. And then obviously you're going to repeat that again. Okay, so shall I repeat it? Are we okay?
So what do? You put 4 on either side again?
Yep, so literally you will keep doing that, okay? And then what we'll do is I can show you on here.
Yeah,
so let's just take the earring off and then you'll know how to make the earring. So what we do then is we will do, for instance, we've got 8, 8, 8, 8, 8 all the way down and use the size of the bracelet. On the earring, I have done 4 and 4.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the loop that we started off with.
Yeah.
And that loop then is where I attached my beautiful earring finding.
Lovely.
Okay, jump ring, earring finding. Then if we come to the end, I've done exactly the same. I added 4 crimp.
Yeah.
And then what I did was I just put the tail of the right strand back through to form that loop to finish off with. Then I crimped it and that made the same as the beginning. Okay, so that's our second crimp.
Right, okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And then I used a fine head pin.
The featherweight ones
again. Added 2
lovely.
On, made a jump ring, put that on, and then that makes an earring to match.
Isn't that gorgeous? And it's lovely, actually, that you've altered the amount of lab dryers that you've used for the earrings. Because as you say, you don't necessarily want that kind of really, really, really long drop. You just want kind of this. You just want to kind of mirror the design rather than replicate it exactly.
Yeah.
But that lab dryer, I have to say, it is designed... It is destined to be set into earrings and bracelets. Something that you can see, something which is going to sparkle. Mm-hmm. This kit is absolutely sensational. £29.95. What a gorgeous kit. Thank you so much, Irene. That's
You're
beautiful.
You're welcome. Beautiful. You can always put a crimp cover over the crimp as
to make
well.
It look like a little
space
bead.
Yeah, if you
bead.
Wanted to. But I felt because the beads were so delicate, I didn't want to do that. But
no, I totally agree. Yeah. I think what you've done there is absolutely spot on. Beautiful.
Okay.
Let's go see some of your designs on the Wall of Fame. We're just purely because of time, because we've got so much to fit into the last hour, we're just going to do names and numbers. I hope that's okay. I've got number 31 here, beautiful lace piece, black and green, gorgeous combo. Number 31 is from Linda Sykes. Best of luck to you, darling. We're going to be drawing the Wall of Fame on Wednesday. I'm not here on Wednesday, but it's going to be Lucy who's going to be drawing the Wall of Fame for you. With Mark. Awesome. Best of luck, lovey.
Well, I've got number 32, and that's quite... complimentary colours.
It's like a real colour pop quality, isn't there?
Yeah, beautiful. And that's Sharon Bodie.
Thanks, Sharon.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Number 33 here, lovely blue qualities here, and oh, labradorite calla lilies. Have a look at this. It's number 33, and it's from Caroline Robinson in Northamptonshire. Best of luck to you, Caroline. Beautiful.
Mm.
Gorgeous.
I love the way that this lady is complimented. She's got a pair of earrings, a necklace, and a bracelet all to match.
That's really nice.
Yeah, number 34. Oh, Andrew, I do apologise. Andrew Saunders. Oh, that's beautiful, isn't it?
Thanks, Andrew. Best of luck.
Yeah,
awesome.
Well done.
I've got number 35 here. Beautiful gizmo earrings with pearls and headpins on the bottom. See how effective those headpins are with a little ball on the end. Yeah. And that's from Jonathan Wilde. Best of luck, Jonathan. Gorgeous.
Beautiful.
Oh, and Claire saying that she didn't quite get the shot of the first one.
Oh.
That's fine. It was number 31. It was from Linda Sykes. Beautiful. Gorgeous black and green there. Lovely way of using the lace there. We've had two kits of lace in today. Ruby, emerald and sapphire coming up. Honestly, this is probably the most important opportunity that we're going to be bringing you today. It's coming up in a couple of minutes, and honestly, you have got to be in it to win it with this one. It's seriously, seriously exciting. Don't go anywhere.
The Jewellery Maker Wall of Fame is where you get to showcase your skills as a jewellery designer. Each week, one lucky entrant will win £100 credited to their account, and the runner-up receives £50. If you want to enter your design, just send a photo to studio@jewellerymaker.com, or you can post your photos to Wall of Fame, The Genuine Gemstone Company, Unit 2D, Eagle Road, Moon's Moat, Redditch, B98, 9HF. Get making and good luck! You can now watch clips from Jewellery Maker on our YouTube channel. Get interactive with Jewellery Maker.
We really appreciate your support here at Jewellery Maker, so we'd like to give you something back every time you refer a friend to us. Once your friend's order is delivered, you'll both be rewarded with a free £10 credit to each of your accounts. Simply log on to your account or ask our call centre team to find your refer a friend code, give it to your friend, and have them type it into the refer box when they sign up online. Alternatively, give the code to our friendly call centre team and they'll do the rest. So come and bring your friends into the fabulous world of jewellery making. Jewellery Maker, share your passion.
You can now keep in touch by following Jewellery Maker on Twitter. Get interactive with Jewellery Maker.
Join Vicky Carr for her baby shower on Friday the 24th of April morning show. There'll be lots of fun, extra special JM treats, and Vicky will be joined by Angela, the JM Business Academy guru. It will be a morning show not to miss, Friday the 24th of April from 9 a.m.
Do you have a question that you need answering?
Well, did you know you can ask to speak to an accredited jewellery professional in our call centre?
Trained by the GIA, you can ask us any gemological question and we'll do our best to help.
We don't just sell gemstones, we know gemstones.
That's why when you buy from us, you're buying with confidence. Buy your genuine gemstones from genuine accredited jewellery professionals. Come and join Jewellery Maker on Facebook and get involved with over 50,000 people who have liked us. You'll get up-to-date information about our channel from the latest images of designs by our fantastic guests, gossip on what is coming up in the shows, and the newest information on our workshops. You can get in contact with jewellery makers all over the world and get some fantastic hints and tips. Simply search Jewellery Maker in the search box or go to facebook.com/jewellerymakeruk and you're there. You don't even need to have a Facebook account. We can't wait to see you there. Jewellery Maker. Create. Wear. Share.
I am a little bit nervous about this, Strand. I'm not going to lie to you. I was with you over the weekend, which was brilliant. We had an amazing couple of shows over the weekend that I was involved with. It was absolutely brilliant. We were able to bring you on Saturday and Sunday, sorry, a couple of strands of ruby, emerald and sapphire. Not too dissimilar to this, actually. They were a little bit longer in length. They were kind of 38 centimetres in length. And they were absolutely gorgeous. we had great big quantities of both those strands. I think we had over 200 of each one of those strands, which is absolutely amazing. And they both sold out, which I was really excited about, and you were really excited about as well. And it got me thinking. And it got me thinking. When I bring you strands of precious gemstones, and we're able to do them for really very, very, very low price points, it makes me feel really good. Honestly, it does. It makes me feel really good because we get people texting in saying, this is the first time I've been able to get kunzite, or it's the first time I've been able to get tanzanite. And it's because it's of that certain price point. The two strands that we bought you over the weekend were absolutely gorgeous. However, I know for a fact that we would have had people watching the show who would have seen those strands and thought, do you know what? Wish I could get that. I wish I could get that. If only it was a little bit more conservatively priced. Don't get me wrong. I think the deals that we bring you on Jewellery Maker are second to none. I'm actually quite embarrassed by the price points that we offer you sometimes on Jewellery Maker, because I personally think that they're too low sometimes, quite a lot of the time. And I end up kind of butting up against producers and the management team, and I say, look, honestly, we're talking about, you know, super, 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 super precious gemstones here. How on earth can we do it at these kind of price points? It's wrong that we're doing it at these price points because they're so precious. But it's about the price points we can offer you, okay? And if we can go lower, then we will. But on this occasion, I spoke to members of our management team yesterday afternoon to see if I could organise a strand of sapphire, ruby and emerald. And I said, I want to be able to fit it into Monday's show. And I want to be able to do it for this price point here, okay? Now, the price point we're going to offer you today, it's lower than where we should be going. It's quite a lot lower than where we should be going. But it was the closest strand I could find and our management team could find to fit the bill. They've given us this strand today on the proviso that we sell every single strand, okay? They all have to go, okay? They all have to go. They said to me, Carol, if you are going to play this strand on Jewellery Maker on Monday morning, tomorrow morning, because it was yesterday, if you're going to play the strand of sapphire, emerald, and ruby on Jewellery Maker tomorrow morning, tomorrow afternoon, and you're going to be playing it at the price point that you say you want to play it at, which is way lower than where it should be, you've got to promise us that you sell all of this strand out. And I said, okay, okay, I'll see what I can do, okay? Right. I really want this strand to sell out. And you can understand, I know you can understand, as viewers of Jewellery Maker, just by looking at this strand and by looking at me, this is not the price point this strand should be. But I get such a kick, and any producer will tell you when they work with me, I get such a kick out of getting people to text in, about when we get people texting in when they get a strand like this and they say, this is the first time I've ever been able to own sapphire, rubies and emeralds because it's £19.95. It's the first time I've ever been able to own a gemstone like this. It's the first time I've ever been able to own three of the big four gemstones. It's the first time I've ever had this opportunity. It's the first time I've ever been able to bring you... it's the first time I've ever been able to buy sapphire, ruby and emerald for under £20. I get such a kick out of getting texts and messages like that in. It makes me feel great. Because do you know what, Irene? I believe that gemstones like this should be available to everyone. Gemstones like this should be available to absolutely every jewellery maker viewer out there. Don't you agree?
I think it's lovely that it's all on one strand and they've got a variety. Because the way those colours are coming together is gorgeous.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. How lucky are you to get that strand? Absolutely beautiful.
how lucky am I to be able to be given this strand by a management team? And honestly, we do have a nice big quantity of this. It is 100% brand new, and they gave me this strand on the proviso that every single one of these strands was to sell out on today's show. They said, if you're going to be taking this strand below £20, you have to promise us that you are going to sell every single one of these strands. Well, it looks like it is going to sell out. It looks like they are going to all go on today's show. The amount of multi-bidders I've got coming through is making it really difficult for me to tell actually how many we've got left of these. I don't know how many we've got left, but we've got... I've got a screen full of names. I've got a screen full of names. it is my absolute pleasure to be able to bring you Ruby, Emerald and Sapphire for under £20. I've been a little bit, well, no, I don't feel bad about it at all. Yesterday afternoon I felt a bit bad about badgering our management team on the weekend and saying, look, we've had a strand of Ruby, Emerald and Sapphire on Saturday show and Sunday show. Can we please do one tomorrow that's even lower in price point? And yes, it's not. I mean, the ones that we bought you over the weekend were kind of 39 centimetres in length. They were absolutely beautiful. But I was so determined to be able to bring you a similar kind of strand, or as close as I could, for less than £20 today, because it's so important that we offer people, all of our viewers, gemstones of this kind of calibre, just so we can show you, just so we can prove to you, you can have this quality. You can have this this incredible quality. You can have rubies, emeralds and sapphires from Jewellery Maker, and you can get them for under £20. Certainly not every day of the week. And in this occasion, it shouldn't have been under £20. But do you know what? I said to our management team, I promise I will do my very, very best to sell every single one of these strands for out today. And I am going to sell it for less than £20, because that is the kind of quality I want to be able to give to our customers today. Well done. How many do we start off with, Phil? Okay, we started off with 254 strands of this. I can now say that we have got how many left? Or how many have gone? Wow, 180 chances have been taken. I've got 40 chances in baskets, so people, you need to... people, sorry, that was such a rude thing to say. You really need to check your baskets out. You have to check your baskets out. I'm determined for all of these to go today, honestly, because, oh my word.
I'd love a
loads
pair
and loads of people
ruby.
Coming through for this. Sorry, Irene, what was that?
Yeah, I was going to say I'd love a pair of ruby earrings, sapphire earrings.
Yeah.
That's just two things I'd have out of that. And just one pair of ruby earrings for £20 would be beautiful, because I've never had a pair of ruby earrings.
I know, but this is
that
it.
That is beautiful. And emerald as well.
Now, every single one of our jewellery makers, all those jewellery makers who text in and you say, oh, you know, oh, God, oh, can't the price be a little bit lower? You know, I'm never going to be able to own gemstones like this. This is for you. This is for you. This is for people who we get Wall of Fame entries from, who say, you know, I'd love to be able to set this with ruby, I'd love to be able to set this with emerald, but, you know, I'm never going to be able to afford those. This is for you. This is for you, okay? Get it, add it to your order, enjoy it. Karen says, loving the show. I've just got two. Thank you, Karen and Jewellery Maker. And that's Karen in Bristol. It's my absolute pleasure. I shouldn't have done it. I do feel a bit bad for badgering the management team about it, especially over the weekend. But do you know what? I was so determined to be able to bring every single one of you the opportunity, because not everyone's budget stretches that far. Not everyone's budget stretches to kind of £30-40 per strand. And I'll show you in a moment. Well, the quality I'm bringing you today, you can see, absolutely exceptional. It shouldn't have been £19.95. But I made a pact with our management team, and you know what, that's it. I'm so pleased I could do this for you. Eileen says, hi Carol, I've just bought two strands as my major buy. Thank you very much. That's from Eileen. Brilliant. Oh, I love it. I love getting messages like this. 57 pence per carat, bonkers, but thank you. Awesome, yeah. Wow. I think I'll just get it now, ask questions later, really. And one more. Rosemary in Somerset. Many thanks, Carol and team. I've had bad news. I've had a bad news week, having to have fourth spot. Oh, you are kidding me. Oh, Rosemary, that's not good news, is it? That's really, oh no. Lovely. I'm so glad that's cheered you up. That makes me feel good that we've cheered you up with this. That makes me feel really, really good. Absolutely. And best of luck, Rosemary. Let us know how you're getting on. Oh, sweetie. Absolutely fantastic, though. Well done, everyone. Brilliant. Now, I've got 30 chances left. I've got 30 of you with this in your baskets. Please check your baskets out. Otherwise, I'm going to look like a right Wally. I really will do. Right. I've now got another section. Philip has cobbled this together. He's literally cobbled this together. Because this section of pre-birthday treats went so well, do you know what we're going to do now? Another little section of pre-birthday treats. This, I've got two strands which have literally just arrived in the building about 5 minutes ago. When I say just arrived in the building, they actually arrived in the country this morning. They arrived at our warehouse and they've come straight over here. I've got gee whiz, that is beautiful. You sure this isn't just a promo? We can do this today? We can do this. Can we do this now, or are we going to save it for a bit, or when are we doing it? Seriously? Okay. Can I give you a little preview of something we've got coming up in a couple of seconds? What gemstone do you reckon this is? I can honestly say, if anybody guesses what gemstone this is, I personally will send you £5 of my own money. Absolutely. I will do that. I will do that. Text in, what gemstone do you think this is? I don't think anyone is going to get this. I don't think anyone is going to... And no, nobody can text in from the show. None of the crew members. Matt's like, shucks. Nobody who's involved with jewellery making can text in. If you... I'm going to look like such an idiot if I get 10 people with right answers here. But honestly, I don't think anyone's going to guess it. But if anybody gets that answer correct, I'll personally send you £5 on my own hard-earned cash. Okay. That's coming up in one opportunity's time. First opportunity. These have literally just arrived in the building. They've just arrived in the country. Oh. Tanzanite 6mm rounds. Oh, my word. I feel... Did you just drop your strand then? Do you just drop something then? Huh? What? I literally feel like I'm in the presence of royalty here. I've gone all hot.
I'm liking that.
Irene, look at that.
Loving them. Look at them. They're fabulous.
You can tell that's tanzanite, can't you?
I'm loving it. I love it. 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 Love it.
You can just look at that and
six
go...
6 mil.
Yeah, it's tanzanite.
6 mil.
Normally...
Nice.
We're talking tanzanite nuggets.
Hmm.
Or, at the very, very best, faceted rondelles.
Yeah. Chips.
Chips, yeah. Mm. These... are 6mm highly polished rounds.
Very
to
nice.
Say this gemstone is rare is probably the biggest understatement of the year. This gemstone is currently being mined 600 to 800 meters below ground level. We're getting to the point now with tanzanite mining where it's almost impossible to get machinery any lower and to get miners any lower. We're talking that for a period of 2 months from one of the main tanzanite mine shafts, no gem quality tanzanite at all was uncovered. We're talking about a gemstone that is probably at its highest demand ever, and unfortunately is in one of its lowest areas of mining. There is barely any of this gemstone about. Steve Bennett, who's the founder of the Genuine Gemstone Company, was at the Hong Kong Gem Fair about a month ago. It's the largest gem fair in the world. When he arrived at the Hong Kong Gem Fair, I'm talking about gem quality tanzanite here rather than bead quality, which is what this is. He was looking for tanzanite. Simple, plain and simple. We go direct to mines, so we go direct to the tanzanite mines and the artisanal miners who mine for this gemstone. He was offered tanzanite. He wasn't given a price per carat. It was a simple case of, let us know your best price and we'll get back to you at the end of the show to let you know if you've been successful. Well, that is just pointless because it's sealed bids and it's people, you could be paying. Well, to put it this way, Steve has said that the price per carat weight of gem quality tanzanite has risen, in some cases, 200 to 300% in the last couple of years. That is worrying times. And from my conversations with Steve over the last few months, and I've said to Steve, look, when is this going to happen? When is this going to start to affect bead quality tanzanite? And he said, look, I don't know. Could be within the next month. Could be within the next year. It might never happen. You might be lucky enough that you can always get hold of bead quality tanzanite. My personal thoughts are, if I was sitting at home right now, I'd buy two strands. One strand to work with and another strand to do absolutely nothing with and see what happens to the price of tanzanite over the next 5 years. Keep it. Don't do anything with it. We have guest designers like Jan who intersperse three or four from a strand like this into a pearl set, and that can elevate the price of a pearl set that she has sold in the past from being £120 for a pearl set to more like £180 just by using half a dozen of these gemstones. We've had a gentleman called Jason who's made jewellery from tanzanite necklaces, earrings, bracelets. He had a customer who bought a necklace and bracelet tanzanite set, who then came back to him a couple of months later and said, could you make me a bracelet as well? And we're talking the necklace, I think was the necklace 295 he sold that for? Something like that. It was mainly tanzanite. And the earrings were 175, I think. And the bracelet, I can't remember how much the bracelet was, but I think those are the right price point. Jason, if you're watching, text in and let us know if I'm right about that. You are talking about a gemstone of serious prestige, serious quality. Price point on this, I've got absolutely no idea because it's a brand new strand. I haven't even seen the strand till about 5 minutes ago. All I know is well over a quarter of the stock has been allocated. I've got probably about 20 or 30 people waiting on the phone lines to see how low this is going to go. Here's your deal today. Oh my word.
Isn't it? You know, it's like you say, if it keeps going down and less, you've got to buy one just to keep it as a collectible and save it, like you said. What a fantastic price. And they are so beautiful. Well, smoothly made. Lovely.
I'm not being funny, Irene, but if you took, I was going to say six of these, but I reckon even if you took two of these, made them into drop earrings, set them with precious metal.
Yeah.
I reckon you could probably sell them for about £60, oh, 60, gosh, 70
yeah.
pounds.
Yeah. Beautiful.
You've got an entire strand of the. I don't know what price I was expecting to see. I have no idea what price I was expecting to see, and I actually didn't have a preconceived kind of price, for very, very rarely in my case, because I normally do. I normally look at something and say, it's going to be that price. But I don't know what price I was expecting for. But that's ridiculous. That is absolutely. That is amazing. That is absolutely incredible. That is just unbelievable. Someone's asking how long the strand is. I'll just measure it for you. I should imagine it's about 30 something. It's about 38 normally. Let me just double check for you though. 30. Oh my word. It's 42 centimetres.
Wow.
It's 42 centimetres in length. Is that right? That can't be right. 30. Okay, I'm going to guarantee you 38 centimetres. I'm going to guarantee 38 centimetres. This one I've got here is actually 41 and a half centimetres in length. Oh my word, that is ridiculous, isn't it? That has shocked me. That really has shocked me. Because this, I'm not trying to say that this is gem quality tanzanite at all. But you can tell it's tanzanite by the colour. You absolutely can do. That is beautiful. And do you know what? In some cases, I'd rather have bead quality tanzanite with this level of colour than gem quality tanzanite with a much, much, much lighter colour. Because this, for me, is a truer tanzanite colour. This has got a truer tanzanite character. And I tell you something, if this was gem quality tanzanite, it wouldn't be on this channel. Unfortunately, it wouldn't be on this channel. It would be set into jewellery on our sister channels. Right. Luckily, nobody has got this right, which I'm really glad about. because I said, if you could guess what this gemstone was, I would give you five. I would personally send you £5 of my money. And I don't have a lot of £5 notes, I have to say. Raymond says, star diopside? No. Jet? No. Obsidian? No. And there's loads and loads and loads. I'm really glad all of these are wrong. So I'd have to send you £5. this gemstone, I don't think I've ever bought you before on Jewellery Maker. If I have, I've maybe bought you one strand. Do you know what this gemstone is, by the way, Irene?
I know what I'd love it to be.
Do you know what it is?
No.
What do you think it might be?
I'd love it to be like a black onyx.
Black onyx? No. Nope.
Do you know what it is? He knows what it is.
I know Matt knows what it is.
How rude.
I'm not going to send him £5 though. You don't know what it is because we told you what it is and you can see on your screen what it is. This is...
I've never seen so many stuff off. Come near.
Hey?
When you said I'll give you £5, I've never seen all the staff come so close to to you as he's queuing
like,
up.
Can I go on my break now, please, so I can just text him?
£5.
Right. This is one of the rarest gemstones on planet Earth.
Oh.
Natural black moldavite. Right. This can also be classed as natural glass. You have got an incredible gemstone here. The bulk of the moldavite I've bought you over the past 7 years on our sister channels has been from the Czech Republic, which is where this is from actually, and was created by a meteorite that hit the Czech Republic at over 45,000 miles an hour about 15 million years ago.
Wow.
That is the bulk of the moldavite that I've bought you in the past. Now, when this gemstone was formed and forged, it was done so at immensely high temperatures, okay? It was created at immensely high temperatures, and as a result of this gemstone being formed, gases were created by elements which were smashed together. Now, a lot of the green moldavite that you'll see on our sister channels has got tiny little air bubbles in it. And those little bubbles are filled with gases which aren't found on planet Earth. For many, many years, gemologists believe that moldavite came from outer space and that it was sent down from outer space. To a certain extent, they were kind of right, because it can only be from something kind of supersonic that this gemstone is created. So either by meteorite impact, which is where the majority of moldavite that I've bought you over the past 7-8 years has been from, or by lightning striking sand. Because to create natural glass, you've got to have sand. You've got to have a kind of like a sandy-like substance. And you've got to have a lot of heat. When we talk about obsidian, we talk about natural volcanic glass, which is when molten hot lava meets something very cool, so something like water. You have to have extreme heat and something else to bash together to create this incredible material. Personally, I've never bought you black moldavites. On Jewellery Maker, on Black Jewellery, sorry, on Black Jewellery, on Jewellery Maker, I think I've only ever bought you moldavite once. I've never seen moldavite in rounds, ever. I've only ever seen it in nuggets. I've only ever seen it in nuggets. I've never, ever, 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 ever seen it in rounds. This is natural glass. And do you know something? The estimated amount of moldavite scattered around planet Earth only weighs about 275 tons. That's it. That's it. You think about how many hundreds and thousands, maybe even millions of tons of diamonds there are in the world. The amount of moldavite scattered around the world is estimated to be about 275 tons. That is nothing. That is nothing. That's like a suitcase full of gemstones in comparison to the truckloads of other gemstones that there are, like diamonds, for instance, which are some of the most valuable gems on planet Earth. Now, price point for this. Again, I've got no idea. I've only bought you moldavite maybe once on Jewellery Maker. That is absolutely it. Natural glass, natural black moldavite. You have got something here which is going to blow your socks off. It's going to blow your mind. Today, this is your price. I've got no idea how low this is going to go. Oh, that's amazing. What? Oh, my word. I've got loads of interest. I've got Fleur, guest designer Fleur, back on the phones for this. Sorry, back and on the web for this. Lots and lots and lots of interest on the web and the phone lines for this. Well done, everyone. Natural volcanic glass, natural moldavite. Now, whilst I blow my nose, Irene, why don't you kind of explain what you would do with this and how you would kind of give this a good platform?
Well, straight away, I'm thinking about those beautiful corals that we had earlier. So I think that colour with the coral would be beautiful. But I think I would like to buy some pure silver stones or even a nice glass clear stone, which is like what we had earlier, and just put them in between them. Or I might just make a beautiful set like a pearl because they speak for themselves. But there's lots of ideas because it being black and the purity of how strong that black is, it's going with anything. But I think I like it with the coral as well.
I think so something which is going to contrast against this gemstone.
Yeah.
I think when you've got something like natural black moldavite or natural volcanic glass, I think really you've got to think about who this is going to be for, who this jewellery is going to be for. It's going to need to be for somebody who's going to appreciate what this gemstone is, how rare it is. So maybe to somebody who you're trying to educate about gemstones. I think you can only do yourself a favour if when you set this into jewellery, you write a little synopsis about this gemstone and give it away with the gemstone, because it's all about education. With a gemstone like this, it is such an unassuming looking gemstone, isn't it? It reminds me a little bit of black spinel, but it's such an unassuming looking gemstone. But actually what you're physically getting here is a minor miracle. You really are getting a miracle here. I mean, it really is one of the most incredibly formed gemstones the world has ever known. Michelle says, only ever seen it in rough nuggets before. It looks phenomenal, says Shelley from Hartlepool. I think that's a really good word to describe it, actually. It is a phenomenal gemstone. You've got a gemstone here which either forms when lightning hits sand or when meteorites hit planet Earth. That really is the only way that you're going to get this gemstone. Absolutely go nuts for this gemstone. Whoever you give this to, however you set this into your jewellery, make sure that you are aware and that whoever your customer base is or whoever you're going to be giving this to knows the worth of this gemstone, because it is exceptionally rare. Fleur, guest designer Fleur, says, one of them in the middle of that citrine, I'm going to use mine with amber. Bought a few months ago. Do you know what? Using it with amber, what a great idea. Using it with a gemstone that formed 50, 60 million years ago, alongside moldavite, you know, wow, what a great idea. And of course, they would be kind of neighbours almost, because our Baltic amber comes from Poland, and this gorgeous natural black moldavite, natural glass, comes from the Czech Republic. What a great idea. Well done, Fleur. Awesome. Gorgeous. Well done. Right, next. Next. Like I say, this is all Phil's idea. Let's do some pre-birthday treats just before the end of the show. Do you know what's just what I was thinking, Phil? I hadn't actually picked this strand up till now. I just looked at it. You're kidding me. Seriously?
It's beautiful.
It is, isn't it? Right. When I first started bringing you Apatite on our sister channels, which must have been about 5 years ago, I as a presenter, was fed information by Steve Bennett, the founder of the Genuine Gemstone Company, about this gemstone. And one of the main things that I will remember about this gemstone is when you get apatite, which is natural, which this is, when you get apatite, which is pretty much gem quality, which is pretty much what this is, it is very, very rare to find this gemstone over a carat in size. The average size for apatite of gem quality that's natural is about 15 points. In this single strand, there's 135 carats of gemstones. Now, just to give you an idea about how big a 15 point apatite is, it's about a 1 to 2 mil size gemstone. The gemstones on this strand are between 5 by 3, amazing considering what I've just said, to 11 by 6 mil. Now, arguably, yes, you could say, well, there's some moments here where it's more translucent than transparent. You're going to be getting predominantly a bead quality here. You are getting moments which are gem quality gemstones, but you are mainly going to be getting some bead quality ones here. And yeah, I'd kind of go with that, but it's natural. And these gemstones are absolutely enormous. So first of all, I think we can all appreciate here that what we're getting here is really, really, really rare. Yeah? There's 135 carats in total. That's a huge carat weight. Now, Irene is going to be going, not that I'm jealous at all, to the Dominican Republic with her husband for his birthday. Lovely. I hope you have a wonderful time.
Thank you.
This is, and Irene was saying to me, what gemstone should I look out for when I go to the Dominican Republic? Obviously, I said Larimar. This is the kind of colour of top quality Larimar. And it goes with the Dominican Republic. It goes with that kind of Caribbean lagoon blue kind of... I mean, don't you look at that and just think sunshine, sandy beaches and cocktails.
The sea. Yeah. That's the first thing when I seen that, I thought how clear, like a waterfall, and yeah, that beautiful, where the sun's shining, oh, it's going to be gorgeous, isn't it?
That is going to be amazing. You've got to get a strand of this iron and make some earrings or something out of it.
Yeah.
An amazing price for this today, and I do mean amazing. Every single spring and summer, this gemstone comes back into its own. And we sell more and more and more strands of these at the hotter the weather gets. It's almost a bit of a barometer. You can tell how hot the weather is by how many strands of turquoise and apatite we sell on Jewellery Maker. Because the hotter it gets, the more we seem to sell. And it's because it's such a summery, hot, beautiful gemstone. It's got such a wonderful calming influence. And it looks fantastic if you've got a bit of a tan as well. 135 carats. Here's your price point today for this incredible strand. £24.95. It is absolutely 100% brand new. I've got loads and loads and loads of people already confirming and coming through to get this who didn't even know the price point. Well done to everyone there. Absolutely amazing. Plus, you're going to get a 30-day money-back guarantee as well. But to be able to bring you natural apatite between 5 by 3 to 11 by 6 millimetres in diameter is absolutely astonishing. And it's all hand-faceted and it's all hand-drilled as well, which is just amazing. Emily says, I see perfect blue seas. It's becoming my number one. I put it with peridot. What a lovely idea. Never thought of it with peridot before. That's going to look great. She'll have like a lovely grassy green with the sky blue. Yeah, that's going to look great. Emily, why have I never thought of that? Oh, Director Claire saying she put it with champagne pearls. What about with the citrine? What about with the citrine? Oh, that with one of the best strands of citrine I've ever seen in my entire life.
That's nice.
Jan just turned around when she heard us say that. She can't help herself. She literally can't help herself. Citrine, amazing. Yeah, I know. It is amazing.
It's beautiful.
It is amazing. How much was the citrine, by the way? $24.95. She's off to order it. There we go. Honestly, it doesn't take much persuading with Jan. And she will. She'll go and order it now. She'll probably order two strands. She hasn't even held it. But it's all about just knowing, Irene, isn't it? You know, you know that the quality is going to be great from Jewellery Maker. You know the price points are going to be great. So you may as well just get it.
Yeah. Thing is, there's always enough on that strand for you to have a treat and to do it as a business as well.
Yeah.
So you make a few items, and then the odd few that's left, you have a treat for all your hard work.
Oh, you see, I like your trail of thought there.
Especially if it's those rubies, those emeralds.
You keep
on that
going
strand.
On about this strand. You know, want this strand, don't you?
I know, I love it. I love colour, and you have every colour there that you need. I really love that.
No, let's just have one more look at it, shall we? Shall we have one more look
it's
at
gorgeous.
It?
Gorgeous.
Nine left. Oh, Irene.
That's not nice.
You've got to, haven't you?
Yeah, I think I like that. I do like that one.
You've got to get it.
Yeah.
Just take one of each of the gemstones there.
I'd have that, you know, as it is.
Two of each of the gemstones. Make earrings out of them.
Yeah, I could take those out, but I would just wear that as a beautiful, dainty necklace.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's
bracelet.
Just going to go. Yeah, it's going to go with everything.
Oh, my word. That's exactly what I do. I'm such a lazy jewellery maker, but that's what I do.
No, I like that.
I love being a bit lazy sometimes. No, I am. I'm such a lazy jewellery maker when it comes to stuff like that, but that's what I do. Okay, fluorite. It'll be fluorite on the night.
I like that.
I've started the old pun train as well. Goodness me. Fluorite-y then. Oh, Ace Ventura Pet Detective was on the TV last night. Oh, I love Jim Carrey. I love Jim Carrey with all of my heart, almost as much as I loved Robin Williams. They are just two peas in a pod. Anyway, fluorite. Have they done a movie together? Did they ever do a movie together? Did they not? Robin Williams and Jim Carrey. Can you imagine that? That'd just be bonkers, wouldn't it? Steve Carell and Jim Carrey together are bad enough, aren't they? I mean, they're just hilarious. Oh, gosh, isn't it? Bruce Almighty when he's reading news. Oh, it's just so funny. I love it. Have you seen the outtakes of that as well? When he sets his hair on fire. It's just the funniest thing in the whole world. I love it. Anyway, I love to dance the cha-cha. Right, so multicolour fluorite. Right, totally natural multicolour fluorite. Yellows, purples, greens, blues, the lot. I'm kind of sick of saying this, but I'll say it again. Fluorite is not an easy gemstone to cut. It's not an easy gemstone to mine. You've got a gemstone here which is hand faceted and hand drilled. It's not easy to do that. Fluorite is only 4 on the Mohs scale, so it's very, very difficult to facet and to drill. This is why we normally bring you fluorite in nuggets or cabochons on our sister channels. Here, it's highly faceted, it's highly drilled, and it just looks like it's been a piece of cake to do that, doesn't it? But I tell you what, those lapidaries must have trained for absolute yonks to be able to facet and to drill gemstones of this kind of caliber, which are absolutely beautiful and totally natural, but inherently very, very difficult to work with. Once they're faceted, once they're drilled, they're lovely. Absolutely gorgeous, and they'll behave really, really well for you. Absolutely 100%. But to actually drill and facet a gemstone, to actually physically apply pressure to a gemstone like this, is very, very tricky indeed. Looks amazing, doesn't it? Totally and utterly natural. highly fluorescent gemstone. Get this into sunlight, like, and I mean bright sunshine, bright ultraviolet light, or if you go discotheking, then take it to the disc girl and put it in the ultraviolet light and see what happens. It will glow. It's highly, highly, highly fluorescent. It fluoresces. It's amazing. So it's fluorescent when you place it underneath ultraviolet light. It will glow in sunlight. It's absolutely glorious. I love it. The colour will look even better in sunlight than it does here. Price point for this? Under 20. Oh, what a whopper cheeker. Here's your deal. £17.95. Absolutely glorious. I think it's a lovely colour combination for maybe a wedding, don't you think, Irene?
Yeah, well, I was just thinking how nice it would be to make sort of daisy flowers with five of them looped round and one in the main piece, and probably do a feature with about three of them, just staggered with a little bit of probably quite a fair few strands of your beading in the goldy colour, you know, your beading strands, and then do the flowers coming off so it's got a softer, come natural look to it.
Yeah, because of that drop shape, they are going to work really beautifully as petals on flowers, aren't they?
Or be really nice, because they'll all go to, yeah.
With some fine silver wire, maybe.
Well, the gold colour, probably the gold.
You do gold?
Yeah, I think so, because you've got a warmth in there, so I think the gold needs to pop that.
Yeah.
And I have noticed on that strand you've got there, you see, I'd look at the strands and I'd pick out certain colours.
Yeah.
And you've got two quite nice greeny sea colours.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
And those would make a nice pair of earrings.
It's like a sea green, isn't it?
Yeah, beautiful. Those two.
Gorgeous, gorgeous quality there. Well done, £17.95. Right, now. Very, very quick deals to finish the show off with. Then we're going to go over to Irene.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Excuse me, sorry. Did you hear that? Sorry. Oh, I just burped. Sorry. Sorry if you heard that. So it's bumpy. Irene did.
We did. Mum, no, I don't think you heard it on there. I just think we heard you go, ah.
Sorry, yeah. She's been very kind. I did let a burp out then, I'm sorry. I can't help it at the minute. Doesn't matter how much Gaviscon I have, or whatever, Tums, or whatever they're called. Horrendous, honestly. I had to sleep sitting up last night, again.
Glass of milk, maybe the milk
will Nothing help. Helps, Irene. No. Doesn't matter how much I literally swig it out of the bottle, like, oh, it's just, anyway. Multicolour madness. Quartzite rondelles here. Having a good old chat over there, aren't they, Amelia and Coral? Good old mother's meeting there. Sorry. Gonna get the cake out as well. Blimey. Quartzite faceted rondelles here, all 4x2mm in diameter. You could graduate these colours if you want to. I like them all jumbled together like that, don't you, Irene?
I want that strand.
Do you? You want everything on today's show, Irene.
I like that. I really like that strand.
It's nice, isn't it? Just make lovely little stretchy bracelets out of these.
It reminds me of, do you remember those necklaces that used to be quite long and then you'd wrap it round a few times? Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, just simple jewellery.
Beautiful.
Really gorgeous, lovely decadent colours in here. Really quite blush colours in here as well. Really, really pretty. Okay, two strands in total. How much are we going to, what are we going to be doing, Phil? Oh, just do it. Oh. Just bring it on. You're going to love this, Irene.
Am I allowed to take those ones if they sell out?
£6.95, there you go.
I want them, yeah. I'm
you love your
those.
Rondelles, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I do like rondelles.
You love
rondelles.
Your colour.
Yeah. Oh, I love the colour. Yeah, love colour.
So Irene's going to be getting these two strands today for £6.95. She's also going to be getting this one here.
Yep.
Which is the ruby emerald and sapphire for £19.95. You could mix them together if you wanted to.
Yeah,
I don't see why not.
That's my evening and my daytime.
Yes.
Yep. It is. I like them.
But lovely them. Holiday capsule love wardrobe them. Pieces, couldn't you?
Yeah. I've got a lovely white lace top and I'm going to get them. I like them.
Perfect.
Yep.
Awesome. Deal done. Irene wants to secure a couple of these bad boys. Well done, everyone. Loads of people coming through for these. I've got Vidya, I've got Carol, I've got Anonymous, Mary, Anonymous, Sylvia, Helen, Marjorie, Betty, Margaret, Anonymous, Sharon, Pam, Glenys, Marjorie, Candy, Anonymous, Elaine, Sue, there's loads of you. But do you know what? Jan, guest designer, she's over there putting her jewellery up there. She's pretending that she's kind of doing some work in here. She's not actually. She's actually keeps looking over. She keeps looking over to see what we're bringing to you. If she's probably actually got a pen and pencil over there as well, and a bit of paper to write down codes. Ask her to what? Irene's hands. Are you writing codes down?
Yeah.
You're writing codes on your... Look, she's writing codes down on her hands.
Hold on. There. Times two. I might go for 2 sets. Smiley face.
I love it. You're so naughty. You could have written like Carol Smells and just keep showing it to camera 5.
I've got really bad short-term memory, you see, so I have to write these things down.
Dear me. Yeah. You're dreadful.
It took me 14 years to find out how to get home.
Am I going over to Irene now? Do I have to?
Yeah, come on.
Think whatever, the heart... Yo-yo maker. Oh, yeah.
How far got can
it?
You go?
Oh, don't.
I've got one here. I've got the heart one.
Oh, have you?
Saying?
Right, yeah. All right, lovey, I'll come over.
Am I supposed to be showing this?
Yes, if you could do a demo in 2 seconds, that'll be amazing, please. Oh. I'm joking.
No,
you don't have to do a demo on that. Don't worry. Made me believe it, though, for a couple of seconds, no. Didn't I?
Oopsie.
Awesome. Oh, look at this. Look at this stuff. I love what you've done here with this Hessian. Love it.
Yeah. That I can show really, really quick. Got time to really, really show that quick.
How long have we got, sweetie? About 3.5 minutes.
I could do it in one.
Go on then. Like a challenge.
Okay, right.
Hessian's at the bottom of your screen there for your ivory and fuchsia woven Hessian at $6.95 for 2 lots of it.
Okay, so basically we're going to do a loop with the end of one, and we're going to take that loop and we're going to pull it down.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to do the same with the other side. This is a little bit messier because obviously we're under pressure.
Making excuses.
Yep. I'll put one through the other.
Yeah.
We have done this before, so I'm sure some people have known. And basically, to apologise. Don't worry, honestly, Carol. People.
That's all right. Pregnant woman bend over. Struggle on the floor, covering your mistakes up.
Do you know they're actually better on the floor? So this one's angling, my cream is angling to my right.
Yeah.
So I take my right strand and I'm going to form a loop and take it through. I'm going to take my left strand and pull it down, keeping them flat. I'm going to take my left strand, make a loop, pull it through the right and pull it down.
Good at this, aren't you?
Yeah, and if it angles to the right, then that's the right strand that you make the loop. Place it through, pull it down. If it angles to the left, make a loop.
To the left round.
Loop it through and pull it down, etc., etc., etc.
That's really therapeutic to do.
Yeah, it is actually. And you can do that with that beautiful cord. Do you remember the nice... the
pendant cord?
Yes, this one.
Oh, is that the same thing?
Yep, exactly the same technique.
Ooh.
Yeah, so if people have liked that and they're not sure, that technique is the same as this technique.
Lovely. That's awesome.
Okay.
We've got the yo-yo maker as well, the heart-shaped one.
Yep.
It works in exactly the same way, doesn't it?
Yes, it's fabulous. You've obviously, just at the peak where you can see the top section, and it's got this little V here.
It's like a wishbone.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly the same technique, up and down, through the holes, and here you just follow it round, back up again, and down. And then once you've done that, you will take them.
Does it matter where your start and end point is on that?
I've found no.
Okay, perfect.
You know, literally take that in there.
And you just do exactly the same
thing?
Yeah,
so up and down. So if I start here, I'm just going to go up, all the way around, all the way back, finish there, take my 2 strands, pull them together, and don't forget, just snip just around the edge.
Oh,
and that is it, my darling.
That's awesome.
You're welcome.
Fabulous. And that's just £6.95. Well done. Right. Okay. Irene, when are you next back on the show?
I do believe it's the 8th. And I think it's bridal. So I think it's morning time. 8th
Good
of May.
Good stuff. 8th of May. Yes. Which is going to be brilliant. Irene, you've been absolutely brilliant today. Thank you so much. If there's anything else you want to add on to your order today, please, please, please do. The Ruby Emerald and Sapphire strand has sold out. Sorry, Irene. Yeah, I know. Sorry. I know. I'm just gutted. Gutted. Sorry. Okay. But you can still get that quartzite bundle if there's any of those left. The quartzite sold out. Has the ruby emerald and sapphire sold out?
Come
3 left. You're going to have to do it straight after the show. 3 left of that ruby emerald and sapphire. Irene, you've been amazing. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Coming up now, sorry, is who's next? Ali's back. Ali and the gorgeous Jan. Don't go anywhere for the designer inspiration show. It's going to be absolutely brilliant. Add that tansel on that one to your order right now. See you in a bit, guys. Bye.
Bye-bye.